just a moment.
Good teams have good specialty teams. Ninth overall, the Detroit Red Wings, and Scotty Bowman, affable guy, hockey knowledge on hockey knowledge. And do you know something about coaches that are that good? You can talk to them all you want, they just don't tell you everything. That was a penalty? No, that wasn't a penalty. That couldn't be a penalty.
Well, Martin Lawrence might be thinking along the same lines, but he's going to serve the 2-minute fine. Holding the call, and the Red Wings will go to the power play. The Islanders have Johnsson and Pilon back with Linden and Lapointe, the forwards. Claude Lapointe playing in his 500th National Hockey League game. Is able to chip it away from Yzerman. The Red Wings have their big boys out on the power play. Yzerman, Shanahan, Fedorov, along with Holmstrom and Lidstrom. This is Johnsson, though, with some room now. Kenny Johnsson lugging it out of his own zone. Moving well into the Detroit end of the ice. Johnsson to the corner. Johnsson killing time. Takes a bump along the boards from Shanahan. And Shanahan peels it back of the Detroit goal. The captain of the Red Wings, Steve Yzerman, sends one cross ice to Lidstrom. Up the middle now comes Fedorov. Sergei Fedorov's been hot. He's had goals each of the last three games. But he and the Red Wings will have to go chase as the Islanders clear. Halfway through this power play, Nicklas Lidstrom, there had been some speculation that he might head back to his native Sweden at the end of this season. He's not elaborated on that much. As the puck is sent in behind the Islander net, Lachance after it, kicked away by Yzerman, and recovered in the corner now by Larionov. He put it in front, but it was broken up by Sekko. And the goaltender Hudson comes way out to keep play moving with the Islanders changing.
Two good moves by Sekko on this penalty killing unit, Howie. Good reads, and it's so important for penalty killers to be able to read the play.
And Pilon blasts one all the way through. 24 seconds remain to the Detroit power play. Red Wings scored three power play goals last night in their 5-5 tie with Florida. Viktor Kozlov. Pardon me, Vyacheslav Kozlov plays it to Larionov. And a centering feed from Brown deflected away. Larry Murphy to Kozlov along the boards. Back now to Murphy at the point. Just did keep it in. Brown, long drive, looking for a deflection from the point. It went off the glass. Lawrence out of the box. Murphy a drive, and that one sails wide. So the Islanders have killed the power play, and now Watt chips it out of the zone. Larionov back to get it. It was Larionov's power play goal late in the third on the power play that tied the game last night at Joe Louis against the Panthers. Red Wings blew a 4-1 lead in the third period. Fell behind 5-4 before that Larionov goal. Reichel floats one in. Tchaikovsky takes off after it. Draper goes to Tchaikovsky. Reichel curls it around the boards. Dandino winds it, but not out. And Brewer sends it right back behind the Detroit goal. Kevin Hodson, the goaltender, shoots one to center. And now McCarty carries in. Brewer stays with him. Richter had poked it loose from McCarty. And Reichel for the Islanders. Put it off Maltby's skate. Tchaikovsky clears. Dandino first to get it. He was being chased from behind by Ted Donato. And now Dandino starts to center. Islanders changing. Dandino drops from McCarty. Long drive, gloved and held by Sallow. 4:37 gone in the opening period. The Islanders have killed the power play.
Feeling burnt out? Tired of the daily grind?
I just...
1-800-COLLECT and the new movie Office Space can help. Make your next call with 1-800-COLLECT, the cheap way to call collect, and you could win a year's pay. Now, every completed 1-800-COLLECT call enters you for a chance to win $50,000,
Greg,
to do whatever you want.
I would do nothing.
The more 1-800-COLLECT calls you make, the more chances you have to win. Call 1-800-COLLECT today and check out the new movie Office Space.
Thank you.
Well, if I told you that the 2,000th shot this season by the Detroit Red Wings was Darren McCarty, you'd have to believe me, because we see it there. Stopped by Tommy Salo. 2,000th shot. The Islanders have had 1,565.
All even in this game. Not on the shot board, but on the scoreboard. But we're early in the first period. Red Wings have had just that one shot by McCarty. Islanders have had two with Kevin Hutson. They look for another one here. Smolinski to Janney. Couldn't slip that one through Holmstrom. So on comes Duck Brown, number 17. Up the left side. Fedorov, long drive, and it's glugged and held by Salo.
Well, you better know it. When scores get into a position, they'll shoot from anywhere, and not a good position, but Fedorov, he's going to be shooting. He gets an opportunity, and you can see there as he delivered the puck. Good balance. I mean, the hands coming off on the left wing side. There's the pass. Here's the shot. Why not? Nothing else to do. Good coverage by the Islanders in their own end of the ice. Fedorov again. Actually, he's looking for a shot that might create a rebound. He's not trying to pick a corner or put it, blow it by Tommy Salo from that angle.
You see that most of his damage this year has been done lately. We told you earlier that he's scored in each of the last three games, and there are concerns about his mindset and just how seriously he was taking this thing earlier in the year.
Now, back-to-back Stanley Cups has a way of kind of lulling a team into a bit of a doldrum. Looking more, you know, just to be respectable in games. And, you know, every team they play is going to do their best to knock off the defending Stanley Cup champion.
Golubovsky at the Detroit line. Floats one cross ice. Yzerman in onside. Snips one, save made. And the rebound blocked by the stick of Chara. The rebound shot was taken by Maltby. And now Palfi up with it. However, the puck had been knocked down with a stick over the shoulders. So play whistle down.
That's the danger, Howie. It's those rebounds. And goaltenders like Tommy Salo and the guy at the other end, Kevin Hodgson, they concentrate so hard on the initial shot. They're not that good. Osgood, who is the backup tonight for Hodgson, is. He can control rebounds much better. But Tommy Salo is an initial shot stopper. He needs help. And at this point, the kind of help he needs is to make sure that the rebound doesn't come roaring back at him, as it did there with Maltby picking up Steve Yzerman as he ripped it through. And there, Maltby slams the rebound at Tommy Salo. And now he's very vulnerable with a second rebound staring at him.
Maltby had two of the Detroit's five goals last night. Former Edmonton Oiler got a real chippy side to him. Nemchinov for the Islanders. It's cross ice to Char, who plays it softly to the Detroit goal. Hodgson tried to hand off to Maltby. Nemchinov, a shot loose in front and cleared to the near boards as Hodgson made the first stop but couldn't control it thereafter. And now Maltby works it up the middle. Barry Murphy slaps it hard around the boards. Maltby tried for Shanahan. Lachance got a piece of it. And now Lapointe works it to Lawrence. Hodgson comes out. Nemchinov after the Karen gets it back. Put it in front. Yzerman broke it up. Then it was batted down with a high stick. But since Brewer, an Islander, was next to touch it, play continues. And a kick save by Hodgson on the Brewer wrister. Offy behind the net, trying to skip away from traffic, does so. Nice move by Ziggy, but he couldn't get that puck through a maze of Red Wings. There's a dive by Kozlov that might have been called as such by Dave Jackson. Now he gets up and takes a return feed. Well, you could almost see Kozlov jump out of his skates on that dive. Erickson, sharp angle, looking for a deflection. He almost nailed the referee, Dave Jackson. Arianov behind the net. Arianov lets it go. Kozlov takes it to the corner and feeds the blue line. Erickson throws it towards the net. That hit an Islander stick. And it's Brewer for New York. And it poked away. Here comes Martin Lapointe into the corner. Richter after him. Centering feed. Batted away. Comes back to Erickson. Tried to feed the slot. That's intercepted. And Chinov just ices it. This one goes all the way down. And Dandino will touch up for the icing call. 12:21 remaining in the first period. The Islanders and the Red Wings. No score.
And whoever said less is more? Hey, more is more. You get more for the money. A lot more for it, honey. You get more for the money, 'cause they gonna treat you right. You get more, more, more for the money.
thousands of people are free to spend less time with their money and more time with their honey. With new Chase Online Banking, it's so easy to check balances, transfer money, pay bills, on your time, wherever you are. So spend less time banking and more time bonding. Open a Chase Better Banking account and get free Chase Online Banking. Chase, the right relationship is everything.
Now, Bill Stewart, the coach, has been working with Eric Brewer, and one of the things you can't do when you're young, well, you do it anyway because you're young, and that's, well, he wants him to be in front of the net. Look at number four as he moves around, guarding that part of the front of the net. Well, not too bad, but here he hesitates. Right now, he should move the puck. You see him hesitate? Look what happened. Woo. Dangerous.
Pilon around for Cherkovsky, played it inadvertently off of Yzerman, and now Cherkovsky takes it out. Long drive, glove. At that spoke wheel by Kevin Hodson, as Cherkovsky let it go from outside.
You know how he's thinking, the Brewer, and you know, you see that doesn't matter whether you're just young. Anytime you make that kind of a move or you hesitate, I don't care if you're Zygmunt Palfy or Brewer, if you decide you're going to do something, do it. The minute you hesitate, give it a second guess, somebody's going to get their stick on you. And there's two of the young players, Brewer and against Toronto on Thursday. You see the number of shifts they had, 19 and 20. And you have to get shifts. If you're going to improve in this league, you have to have good coaching. You've got to have a good support system on the team. And you've got to get ice time.
It's interesting, too. You know, much of what Bill Stewart's been working with in terms of Eric Brewer's growth is his play without the puck and his coverage in front of the net. One of the things he said to him on the ice during a practice session was, hey, you're fine with the puck. And so's Fedorov, snapping that quick shot off that Salo stopped. But there was a mistake with the puck that got Brewer into trouble. And now Pilon plays it behind the Detroit net, but Lapointe was trapped in the zone offside.
You never have to teach offense to good players. They already know how to do all of that. And that's exactly, guys like Rich Pilon should help, and they will help young players. It's a good point when you don't have the puck. Not only be in a good position to do something defensively, but you also have to help offensively. Your defense partner may have the puck. You have to be one of his options. If there's no room or nothing to do up front, you got to be able to move it to somebody, and you have to be there for him. So young Brewer, Eric Brewer, is working on all those with Bill Stewart helping him along.
And I guess you have to be coachable, too, which is something of an understatement. But one of the things that Stewie says he likes about Brewer is just that, the fact that you can talk to him, and he's going to absorb it, and he's going to pick it up. And maybe sometimes you do have to be repetitious, but you know you've got a willing audience, and that's not always the case.
That's not always the case, and yet some players will show it. Usually young players, they know they don't. Listen, they make so many mistakes, and hockey players know when they make a mistake. They're the first ones that know it.
Reichel tried to set up Donato, but it went behind him. And now it's carried to center by Stacy Rost, number 23. Rost heading off on a change, plays it deep. Salo got tangled up with Tomas Holmstrom. Both went down. Play continues, though. Red Wings have it. Murphy a shot, and that's tipped wide. There was traffic in front of Salo as Holmstrom was setting up a screen. Reichel plays it rink-wide to Palfy. Tried to get it back to Reichel. That was slapped away by Larry Murphy. Recently broke one of your contemporary records, or one of your contemporaries' records.
Yes.
18. Timmy Horton for the all-time number of games played by a defenseman in this league.
That is so exciting. What a career he is still having, Larry Murphy. He played with a lot of teams, but he's played well with every team. Basically known as an offensive defenseman, a power play specialist. But you know, he's still solid positionally. If these young players on defense for the Islanders watch players like he in hockey games, they'll see where they should be.
Kozlov dangling. Vyacheslav Kozlov takes it back to the blue line. Away from Jenny. Sets up Larionov. He put it in front. Broken up by Smolinski. Now the Islanders attack four strong. Jenny to Smolinski. He carries to the circle and backhands one off the side of the net. Around to the far side. Smolinski gets it back. Jenny tried to play it in front. Larionov's got him. Now it's Trevor Linden tangled up with Dandino in the corner. Janssen couldn't wheel it towards the slot. It hit the stick of Martin Lapointe, number 20. And Jenny takes it back for New York. 9.5 to go in the scoreless first period. The shots 4-3 in favor of the Islanders.
A lot of checking right now, Howie. The Detroit Red Wings are not going to, you know, just take out and run away and try and blast things at Tommy Salo, they're going to play. They want to get everybody into the game, which is really what they've done with only one penalty in the game so far. That was to the Islanders' LaPointe, but there's a good look at Kozlov. And he can move, as there are many on this hockey club that can move. And his speed and his puck control, some things you have to give players, and he's going to get some ice time. But there, you see, that was Janney. You can't allow, because that opens up ice for somebody else. The minute that you stick check somebody, you don't either move them off the puck or make them do something with it, you're in trouble, because somebody's got to cover up for you then.
Joe Sacco for the Islanders, away from Maltby. Long drive, put it off of Aaron Ward, and the Red Wings go back to the attack. Draper up the middle to McCarty. Party surrounded by white-shirted Islanders, and now Tchaikovsky carries back the other way from the Red Wings line. Tried to slip it around and through Golubovsky. Finally, Sacco takes it. Now behind the net, Watt crisscrosses with Sacco. Out from behind, a shot stopped by Hudson. Oh, Watt found himself with all kinds of time and space. Just Watt and Kevin Hudson, and the goaltender won that one. That keeps us scoreless.
Sprint is creating a world of unlimited possibilities. A world where time and distance don't matter anymore. Call 1-800-PIN-DROP now and switch to Sprint Unlimited. Introducing Sprint Unlimited. The only way to get unlimited calling every Saturday, every Sunday, all weekend long for just $25 a month. And your weekday calls are just a dime a minute. Anytime, anywhere. Come live in a world created around you. A world where weekends never end. Because only Sprint Unlimited gives you unlimited calling every weekend. And every weekday call is just a dime a minute. If you make over an hour of calls each weekend, you could save by switching to Sprint Unlimited. Call 1-800-PIN-DROP now for unlimited ways to save on long distance and leave the past behind. Sprint ahead.
Islanders with some good skating, some good puck control. They create a good scoring chance here. Watt comes out. Look at the time he had and the room. He didn't have to shoot it low. He could have gone high. Easy for me to say up here.
Here's Lawrence firing. That tipped off of Fedorov's stick. Bounces right in front. Lawrence tried to grab it. He had his stick held momentarily, but now recovers the puck. LaPointe behind the net. Nemchinov heads to the front. Now drips back to help LaPointe. And has the puck. This is Nemchinov centering for LaPointe. But it sails straight through to Hudson with LaPointe staring him right in the eyes.
And who was there but Larry Murphy, Howie? We had just talked about him positioning himself and defensively. Yeah, he's put a lot of points up on the board as he put games up going by Tim Horton. But what a spot to be in. It's the only place some players would wander. Watch 55 in red as the Islanders skating well. They're creating scoring chances, and here LaPointe with a rebound. Aha, crossing swords with him. Larry Murphy, be in the right place, stick on the ice. You don't have to put the guy up in the seats, just hold his stick.
From the draw, the Red Wings control. Nicklas Lidström to Fedorov. Fedorov, Shanahan, and Yzerman. That's a picnic for any defense pair. And it's Rich Pilon poking it out of the zone. Islanders have their checking unit of Nemchinov with Lawrence and LaPointe and Will all night. Pilon and Janssen also called on a regular basis to play against this top Detroit Red Wings line. And it's Fedorov sliding it into the Islanders zone. Pilon bats it back the other way. May have iced it here. Murphy being hounded by LaPointe. And LaPointe did a great job to keep the play onside.
Good hustle by Claude LaPointe. But he hustles all the time.
Larry Murphy. You know how long Larry Murphy's been around, put it in perspective. When he broke in, a teammate of his, as Kozlov drives in, stopped by Salo on the rebound put in front. One of Murphy's teammates on defense with the LA Kings that first year in the NHL was former Islander Dave Lewis, who's now an assistant coach with these Red Wings. And a former teammate of yours.
Oh, yes, Louis.
Walensky put it off a leg, and it's recovered by Dandino. Now LaPointe into the Islanders' zone. feeds Kozlov, who centers, and Salo got a piece of that shot from Eriksson.
See, that was an unforced error on the Islanders, Howie. They gave up a good scoring chance.
Linden slips through, kick save, rebound, Smolinski stopped by Hudson. Smolinski on it again. Feeds LaChance. Tried to get it back. Kozlov got a stick on it. Now it's Linden, eliminated by Eriksson. And Kozlov angles for better room before dumping out of the zone. Eric Brewer plays it off the glass with 6.5 remaining in the scoreless period. Teams changing on the fly. LaChance up for Palfi. Ziggy going wide on Dandino. Put it in front, broken up by Brown. Now it's Donato to the corner. Reichel, check there. Ted Donato getting time on the top line tonight. And now Donato tried to put it in front. Brown gobbles it up. And out come the Red Wings, led by Holmstrom. Amos Holmstrom into the Islanders zone. Holds up the trailer ground, a drive and a kick save by Salo. That was a good skate save by Tommy Salo on a tester by Doug Brown. Murphy failed to hold it in. And the puck comes back to LaChance at the Islander blue line.
A little bit of ugliness now, Howie. Players starting to hit a little, use the bodies, and the tempo's picking up. Much better hockey game.
Chara dumps it to the corner. Maltby spins it around the boards. And it's Roast sliding it in. Scotty Bowman certainly figures to roll four lines tonight as a concession to having played last night.
He'd do that anyway, Howie. That's his forte. He uses everybody unless they're not performing.
When he was in Montreal, boy, his specialty was mixing them up, too. LaCordia drive that's finally gathered in by Salo. And some shoving as McCarty and Scott LaChance got into it a little bit. Joe Sacco, pardon me.
A couple of hits, even Zygmunt Palfi moments ago. A little bit behind the play, but handing out a stiff body check. Trying to get some spirit into the Islanders game. They've been playing pretty good. They've been creating some pretty good scoring opportunities, particularly in the last four or five shifts. Detroit here, they move the puck well. They've got guys in motion all the time. Sign of a good team, confident team, always on the move. And here Trevor Linden with a good play at the other end after Tommy Salo had robbed the Detroit Red Wings.
5:14 remaining in the period. Red Wings have Draper, Carty, and Maltby. Pretty good mucking line. I mean, they are as adept at winning the battles in the corners as any line in the National Hockey League.
And Joey Koser would be part of this as well, Howie, only he's been out for quite a while now, he tell me, with an abdominal strain.
Yeah, in fact, he had that injury when the Islanders were in Detroit earlier this month. He was on the mend right around that time, returned a week after the Islanders left Detroit, played briefly, and then had to shut it down again. Now they don't know when he's coming back. That abdominal thing has the tendency to last a long, long time, and with Gino Ojic of the Islanders, it finally necessitated surgery. But he's been around the team a little bit more, trying to rehab his way back. In fact, Gino hopes to be back before the end of the season. The original prognosis was that his season was over, and he's trying to refute that. Joe Sacco behind the Detroit goal. Off to Watt, centers Tchaikovsky, and a nifty stick save by Hudson. And here's McCarty up the right wing. McCarty into the Islander zone, trying to squeeze by Brewer. McCarty put it in front, or tried to. It deflected off the stick of Salo, who had to be alert. And Watt carries up the left side. Watt to Richter, centers for Tchaikovsky, couldn't redirect the puck. Eliminated by Shanahan along the boards. And now Fedorov wields it up the middle. Eriksson saucers one to Yzerman. His drive sticked aside by Salo. Nemchinov on it for the Islanders. Finds Janssen at the other side of the ice. And Janssen played it out, batted into the crowd by Dandino. 3:56 remaining in the first period. Islanders and Red Wings are scoreless.
VIP, America's number one new action show, wants to get your motor running. Watch VIP every weekend and enter the VIP Get Your Motor Running sweepstakes. You could win a cool new 1999 Mazda Miata 10th Anniversary Edition. For details, pick up the February 12th or February 22nd issue of Sports Illustrated or log on to www.vipsweepstakes.com. Get your motor running with VIP and Mazda today. Check your local listings for time and station. Dodge Dakota. Dodge Ram. Add more muscle. In a hurry.
Just under 4 minutes remaining in this first period. It's the Red Wings power line, the Islanders checking line right now. And it's the power of Fedorov in the corner. And Chinov all over him. Fedorov keeps poking at it. Gets some help from Shanahan. And Yzerman finally gets it to Shanahan. Put that one off of Salo. Dandino throws it back in front. Johnson broke it up. Yzerman a drive and a save by Salo. And now it's Fedorov again with Nemchinov on him. Good play by Johnson, who saw that one coming, read it perfectly. And now Nemchinov. Up for Pilon. And this will cost the Islanders an icing as Anders Ericsson makes it official.
I mean, they were doing a very good job defensively. They don't want to play all the time in their own end of the ice with Yzerman and Fedorov handling the puck, and Shanahan, he can pull his way to the net. But I thought the Islanders looked very good positioning themselves. Sergei Nemchinov, player that can do that.
Let's go downstairs to Matt Lachlan.
Howie, coming up in our New York City Marriott Hotels intermission report. I'll be speaking with Mike Watt. We'll find out what it's like to go up against that top line for the Red Wings. Of course, we'll have highlights of the first period, and we'll send you back to the sports desk for an update on what's going on around the world of sports.
All right, Manny, 3:13 to go in this first period. Glad to have Matt with us tonight.
Yeah, exciting to see Matt.
We'll be seeing plenty of him this summer on the Mets tour. Getting ready to rev up. I expect to see you out at Shea 18.
Yes, sir.
Always good for a few games out there.
It's spring training.
Oh, really? Well, you're not messing around, are you? Starting early.
Yep. Gotta go watch a couple of games in Port St. Lucie.
Murphy held it in at the blue line. Linden unable to control it. Lachance and Martin LaPointe, with LaPointe having the step. But Lachance got back to it. Smolinski played it off the glass. And then Linden finds LaPointe of the Islanders. He's all by himself. He's trying to lose his company. He does. But Hoxson beat him with a good save.
Oh, Claude LaPointe. He hustles. He'll make him make mistakes, or he tries to force errors. He's not big, but he plays big. Claude LaPointe, player that everybody says, boy, you really like him, don't you? And I said, I absolutely do. He's an honest, hardworking hockey player. He forces goaltenders to make saves. He's not known as an offensive player, but look at as he powers his way in. Lidstrom trying to hold him, not doing a very good job, as he gets a good scoring chance, all created by himself. He's leading the pack. He's got nowhere to go but to the net.
You know, now, come clean with me. You've got to be honest about something. All the time that you were here while Claude LaPointe was here, I saw Claude seek you out a couple of times. Did you give him some unofficial counsel on, I'm talking about the specifics of his game or even just life in the NHL as an overview. I mean, he seemed like he sought you out more than once.
He and I always had good dialect. We enjoyed talking hockey. And whenever asked, only when asked, I would give an opinion or maybe express a way of doing something a little differently. That's about it.
I mean, it was very, very evident, noticeable. And I sensed there was always little something special between the two of you. And here's Donato. Reichel heading to the net. Donato hits the trailer. Palfi, he shoots and has it deflected away as Murphy got back to take away the scoring chance of Zygmunt Palfi, who now collides with his own man, Donato.
I think Holmstrom come from behind also, Howie, and hooked his arms just as he took the pass. Another good play by the Islanders. They're skating well in this period so far.
Donato down the middle. The Tchaikovsky quick shot off the glass. Donato knocked down in pursuit, but play continues with Yzerman controlling. A minute and a half to go in this scoreless first period. Tchaikovsky left his feet trying to slash it away from Yzerman. And Brewer bats it to center. Tchaikovsky misses Sekko with that pass. Darren McCarty, number 25, for Maltby. Maltby into the zone, forced wide by Pilon. Pilon winds it around. It curls back to center. And we're down to the final minute now of this first period. An offside call there. Or you're at too many men.
I think there's going to be a penalty, Howie. There's no offside there. The puck at the Detroit bench, whistle blowing. I see a lot of red shirts. I thought I could hear somebody yelling. I would not be surprised if it's a penalty for too many men on the ice.
Well, no indication yet. Islanders have held the Red Wings scoreless tonight, and there is going to be a penalty now as Larionov heads into the box. But Islanders have done a pretty good job considering how the Red Wings have had so many fast starts this year.
Yeah, only St. Louis with 66 got more jump of the gun goals than Detroit, but a penalty to the Detroit Red Wings. Larionov in the penalty box. Too many men on the ice. Bench Minor. Well, if we take a look, you can see one, two, three, and there's four, and there's the pass, five, six. And they're all on the ice, and they're playing the puck.
And you were patient enough to count them off one by one while play was going on. I was impressed with that.
Unfortunately, my telestrator right now isn't working the way it should, or we could have really outlined it here.
Uh-oh. Eddie without his crayon. That's a bad omen.
I'm having so much fun, Hallie. I mean, it's almost as if Joe had not taken my place. This is a wonderful hockey game. I'm enjoying it.
We're glad to have you back. Islanders control the puck here on the power play. Richter, wrist shot, saved by Hodgson. Linden peels it away. Tried to center, that was deflected. 10 left to the period. Richter for Linden. 7 seconds left. Linden a shot, stick save, Hodgson, it's still loose. And Fedorov takes it out of harm's way for the Red Wings, and the period expires.
Wow, with the Islanders again knocking on the door. Good coverage by Detroit in front of Hodgson. Rebounds. Islanders aren't going to get any, but Bill Stewart has to be very happy with the way his team played, particularly after the first two or three shifts. For the rest of the period, they were solid.
So Scotty Bowman, who was not a happy man last night, even though his team picked up a point, not happy because they blew a 4-1 third period lead, walks off the ice, you would think, in a somewhat better frame of mind, but he'll never show it.
No, you know, that's why I was looking at you and laughing, Harry, because Scotty Bowman could be absolutely elated that he's not going to show it.
Only time he ever showed some real passion and emotion, or passion's the wrong word, positive emotion, is when he laced up the skates a couple of years ago and took a spin on the ice with the Stanley Cup when the Red Wings won their first one. Second, or at least first intermission, coming up next.
This Week in New York Sports History is brought to you by the History Channel, where the past comes alive.
On February 25th, 1998, the long-awaited sale of the New York Islanders from John Pickett to Stephen Gluckstern and Howard Milstein finally takes place after a problem with the Nassau Coliseum Management Company is resolved.
Officially ended on August 14, 1945, and the baby boom started shortly thereafter. The History Channel, where the past comes alive.
At GEICO, we settle claims quickly so you can get your car back, because no one likes to bum a ride to work. GEICO, a 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Paying too much for car insurance isn't any smarter. GEICO, a 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
During the Lincoln President's Day sale, remember this historic figure. $499. That's a $499 monthly lease for your choice. Lincoln Town Car with all-speed traction control, or the front-wheel drive Lincoln Continental. Two of America's greatest leaders in luxury. See your Lincoln dealer today, because after all, nobody knows more about President's Day sales than Lincoln. What a luxury car should be.
Last year at Foxwoods, we paid out more winners than any other casino, including Eve Wrigley, who won $150 and had the time of her life.
Long Island's hometown team is back. Great tickets to the Saints' next home game are on sale now. Saints fans, get ready for more scoring.
Bring it on.
More hitting.
Bring it on.
More action. action.
Bring it on.
The Saints take on the Syracuse Smash and indoor lacrosse superstar Paul Gates.
Catch the action 1:30 this Sunday.
Bring the kids for a great afternoon of family fun.
Great tickets are on sale at the Nassau Coliseum box office and Ticketmaster.
And kids' tickets start at just $6.
Get ready for New York Saints lacrosse action.
Hometown team.
Hometown pride.
Welcome back, everyone. Scoreless after one. Matt Lachlan joined by Mike Watt of the Islanders. And Mike, you're up against the top line. See, a lot of action normally against the top lines, but this one in particular is awfully dangerous. So what was the key to success in that first period?
Basically having a good forecheck, strong forecheck, and keeping our feet moving. You know, that's the biggest thing. Anytime you play against a team like Detroit, you have to keep your feet moving because offensively, they can really move the puck around. They got some guys with a lot of talent, a lot of speed. And as long as you keep the puck away from them, keep your feet moving, try to slow them down and make them think a little bit more than they're used to. You know, they create a lot of turnovers then.
When do you begin thinking about your assignment and how you're going to approach it?
Usually before the game. I mean, I was playing with Robert and Ziggy there for a while, and I've been used pretty much all over the place this year, playing center, left wing, right wing, and on any combination of lines. So usually the day before practice or the morning skates when I have to get into it.
You like the role that you find yourself in, particularly tonight?
Yeah, it's been pretty good. It's a big challenge. It's a big challenge for our team, and I really like it.
The club had a team meeting after the loss to Toronto. What happened in that meeting in terms of what you can see carrying over into the ice in the first period?
Well, I think our mentality has changed quite a bit. When we played Pittsburgh in New Jersey, when we beat them, we had a real good mentality. We had a lot of confidence, and that's something we have to get back to.
And you think that it's shown in the first 20 minutes, and indeed it has. If you look at the scoreboard, scoreless between the Islanders and the Red Wings here at the Nassau Coliseum. Mike, thanks. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thanks.
We're going to take a short time out. When we come back, it's off to the sports desk, so stay with us.
Overtime. That's what your motor oil's doing up to 3,000 miles of severe driving, okay?
You put off changing it until your protection's as bad as a bunch of figure skaters defending the goal.
Talk about engine abuse.
That's why there's reformulated Quaker State for protection beyond 3,000 miles under any driving conditions. It's been tested, and unlike them, it works. How's that for overtime insurance?
Reformulated Quaker State for protection beyond 3,000 miles. Now available at Aid Auto Stores.
Dodge Caravan. Dodge Durango. It'll be easy to be carried away.
Are you concerned about losing more hair? Do you wonder how much further it will go? Do you wish you could do something about it? Well, there's a pill for men with certain types of hair loss. It's called Propecia. In clinical studies, the vast majority of men, 83%, maintain their current hair count, and most, 66%, regrew some hair. Take it daily and you could see results in as little as 3 months. Propecia is for men only. A small number of men experience certain sexual side effects. Each occurred in less than 2% of men. Women who are or may potentially be pregnant must not use it or handle broken tablets because of the risk of a specific kind of birth defect. Talk to your doctor or pharmacist and read the consumer information they can provide. Propecia. Helping make hair loss history.
When it comes to renting a car, there's really only one place to go. National gets you in your car and on the road fast. So what are you waiting for? National Car Rental. Let's go.
It
It's intermission at the Coliseum, and the Islanders are holding their own against the Wings. I'm Deb Coffin with an update from the MSG Sports Desk. The Florida is coming off of the wild tie against Detroit last night. They're in Toronto playing for the first time at the new arena. This game is scoreless after the first period. In Montreal, though, we have a goal. Damian Rhodes and Jeff Hackett is the goalie matchup. It's 1-0 now. Montreal is there. They are through the first period as well. Here's the goal. It happened very late in the first. 17:57 in. Canadians setting up behind the net, and Mark Recchi will get the centering pass. He beats Rhodes, and it is 1-0 Montreal after the first. The Panthers are back to looking in the rearview mirror. Boston drew into an eighth-place tie with Florida after their 4-3 win over the Caps earlier today. The former Capital Jason Allison scored the game winner. Dmitry Kristich scored a pair of power play goals, but they needed this one with 4 minutes to play in regulation to beat Washington by one and avoid overtime again the final 4-3. The Rangers are off tonight. They play the Penguins tomorrow afternoon in Pittsburgh. Some other news now. College basketball is getting to be tournament time. Rutgers really hurt their NCAA chances by letting an upset opportunity pass them by. A huge game from Tim James in Miami holds off the Scarlet Knights 68-63. And St. John's lost by 6 points today. Shows you the kind of year they're having. 6 points is their worst loss of the season. Villanova basically played themselves into the NCAA tournament. That's their 20th win. Nets and Celtics are just underway. We'll continue with hockey on MSG. Enjoy. We'll see you again a little later. I'm Deb Coffin.
Willie,
it's go time.
Hey.
That creepy mouse with the goggles is back in my apartment.
Really?
Can I hang here?
Absolutely.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
I used to be a car racer.
Oh, wow.
I'm gonna go look at stereos.
Every time we're here, you look at stereos. Then you test them, then you listen to them. Why don't you ever just buy one? They've got Sony, Iowa, Yamaha. The prices are the lowest you've ever seen. You're never gonna find anything better. Just get one. Do it. Buy it. Commit.
You know nothing about men, do you?
We have enough name-brand audio equipment to keep you fooling around for years. Only at The Wiz, your ticket to entertainment.
Hello.
Hello. I just enrolled my company in this healthcare plan, and I need some information on a small procedure.
Oh, fine. Just wait a moment, and we can call Debbie at Central.
Debbie? Who's Debbie? My doctor's not Debbie.
You love Debbie. Debbie's at your healthcare company. She's in charge of your health.
Is she a doctor?
No, but she's really nice. She was a cheerleader. And as long as Debbie's been at your healthcare company, no one here has ever missed a birthday card.
I want my doctor.
Well, we could just ask Debbie.
Is your business healthcare plan all that it should be? Or is Debbie making important decisions about your healthcare?
With HIP coverage, only doctors make healthcare decisions. HIP has added thousands of doctors in private practice to its participating network and offers the lowest priced healthcare option of any major plan with comparable benefits in Metro New York. If you're in charge of your company's healthcare benefits, call your broker or HIP and you'll receive a free brochure and a 10-minute prepaid long distance calling card. Find out why so many are switching to HIP, where business should be.
So where do you get your health care?
It's HIP.
If speed kills, consider yourself fatally wounded.
Man, there was a lot of speed there.
In the blink of an eye, I'm behind you. The ice is my stage. I provide the crowd's roar.
Korea on the north end. He scores! What a spectacular play!
Five-hole, glove side,
top shelf. The goalie's at my mercy. They call me Sniper.
Watch Snipers Take Aim on Fox and ESPN.
Welcome back to the Nassau Coliseum. Howie Rose along with Eddie Westfall back in the building for this nothing-nothing tie, at least at the end of one. So how does it look since you've been away?
Oh, wow. I mean, this is exciting. I thought that was a great first period, Howie. I thought both teams put out the Islanders a little slow in the start, but, I mean, you're playing the Detroit Red Wings, so you're kind of looking at them a little bit. Then you start playing. And then as you play, you start to say, hey, we're doing okay. Not only were they doing okay, they kept everything out of the Islander net. They had some good scoring chances themselves.
Well, the highlights are brought to you by New York City Marriott. A whole lot of goaltending going on.
Yeah, well, Tommy Salo going into this hockey game knows that he's going to have to make some saves. And there's one. And he made several. As always, another right there. Guys that can skate and shoot the puck like the Detroit Red Wings, you're going to have testy moments. Important, the Islanders control the rebounds. Bottle point. There's one of his. good opportunities. Hodgson forced to make a good save, and the Islanders had several. And at the end of the period, Watt with his wraparound, given another chance, easy to say from up here, he might have roofed it.
Oh, Kevin Hodgson playing his first game in over 3 weeks, and Tommy Salo pitching shutouts at the end of one.
New York Islanders hockey on Fox Sports New York is brought to you in part by MCS Cannon, keeping people in business, and by Brooklyn Union. Convert your heat to the comfort and convenience of clean gas heat. It's lifetime energy.
I see your oil burner broke down again. Lucky you. Yeah, lucky you. Because now you can get Brooklyn Union gas heat and enjoy a lifetime of gas heat dependability, gas heat comfort, cleanliness, and convenience. Go ahead. Call Brooklyn Union right now. I'll keep an eye on things.
Get lifetime energy for your home and business. Get Brooklyn Union gas heat. We interrupt this program to bring you the following message. No one duplicates color better than we do. MCS Canon.
To make a big impression, it helps to remember that the little things really aren't so little. Mohegan Sun. Experience the difference of the Mohegan Sun way.
Get excited next time you get behind the wheel. Get into the 99 Pontiac Grand Prix GT Sedan with wide track performance, V6, and a $306 per month GMAC Smart Lease with just $306 due at lease signing. Or the redesigned Grand Am Sedan, solid unibody construction, twin cam engine. Lease for $229 a month with zero money due at lease signing. See your Tri-State Pontiac dealer by March 1st. Hurry.
We sell excitement.
It's coming to the Nassau Coliseum for its only New York appearance.
It's the award-winning International Championship Rodeo.
Featuring six exciting contest events, plus camel racing,
wild and wacky ostrich racing,
dancing horses, daring comedy bullfighters,
plus the Western harmonies of the Sons of Tennessee.
You've seen it on TV, now see it live. Don't miss all the thrills, chills, and spills April 16th through the 18th at the Nassau Coliseum.
Join the fun. Get tickets now
at the Nassau Coliseum and Ticketmaster.
Or charge by phone.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the New York Islanders and Fox Sports New York and intended solely for the private, non-commercial use of our audience. Any publication, reproduction, retransmission, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this game without the express written consent of the Islanders and Fox Sports New York is prohibited. Well, two of our reporters standing by, they can be standing on the ice, next to the ice for the whole hockey game. Literally and figuratively, they never have cold feet.
Always a good view, Eddie, but the story that we're going to talk about, Stan, is the Washington Redskins sale. Howard Milstein, it's not a layup, is it?
Well, the Islanders co-owner looked like he was going to get the team with ease, but it's becoming more and more difficult. Today, a report out of Washington that seven NFL owners are going to turn thumbs down, and he could lose it. In fact, they're talking now that the New York football Giants are going to reject it as well, and that could be pretty difficult. But on the Islanders side, I'm told that they feel that they're going to have the support and they will get the team.
All right, this story has more rounds to go as we begin to play here in the second. Howie?
Thankfully, that story will have some resolution by, the middle of March. I think the deadline is the 12th or 13th, around the time they're going to have that vote. This period begins when the Islanders on the power play for the first minute six as the result of that bench minor against the Red Wings late in the first period. March 16th, I'm told, by our statistician Eric Hornick, is the date they will vote on whether or not Howard Milstein's group does, in fact, get control of the Washington Redskins. And, of course, that will impact the Islanders to some extent. Here's Puff to the slot. Sets up Reichel. He scores! A power play goal, and the Islanders lead it 1-0.
A beautiful passing play, Howie. A little breakdown. Of course, the Detroit Red Wings are a man short, but the Islanders, Robert Reichel with a Beautiful play by Zygmunt Palfi. Watch the play develop in the center ice area. And Reichel will head for the net. Palfi holds the puck, and then down low it goes. Just a little deflection into the open side. Hodgson had to hold to the middle of the ice because that's where the puck was on Zygmunt Palfi's stick. But a quick relay to Robert Reichel, and the Islanders have a 1-0 lead.
So Robert Reichel comes up with his 18th goal of the year, his fourth on the power play. And it comes in the first minute of the second period. Hodgson comes back behind his own net to cut that dump in off. And it's Yzerman shoveling ahead to Dandino. Shanahan turned back by Johnsson. So the Islanders with a lead here against the defending Stanley Cup champions. Shanahan back in the Detroit zone. The Islanders played in Detroit a few weeks ago and lost 5-1. The only New York goal there was scored by Sergei Nemchinov. So now it's Pilon lifting it deep into the Detroit zone. Johnsson picks up the second assist on the Reichel goal. Lawrence after it behind the Red Wings net. Sets up in front. It deflects off the side of the cage. Nemchinov got a stick on it. Now it's Lapointe for New York. Claude Lapointe wields a backhander that's deflected. Erickson takes it off, and Yzerman shoots it ahead. Back to Erickson. Shanahan just left it at the blue line. The Red Wings were changing. And now Nemchinov curls back into his own zone. Chara uses the glass to get it down the ice. And the Islanders will be hit with an icing here as Aaron Ward comes back to touch up. Well, how'd you like to win a big new television? Enter the Watch MSG and win a big TV sweepstakes. Starting Tuesday and throughout March, we'll announce a lucky winner during every Knicks, Rangers, and Yankee game on MSG Network. We'll try to give away a 31-inch RCA TV during 25 games in March, but you've got to be watching MSG to win. To enter, pick up a copy of the New York Post for your official entry blank. Look for the sweepstakes to display at the Wiz store near you, or send a postcard to the address on your screen. Watch MSG and win a big TV, presented by the Wiz and the New York Post. From the draw, Larionov in the Detroit Islanders zone, wields it in front. Kozlov, a backhander, he's stuffed by Salo.
Oh, a beautiful stop by Tommy Salo. Left all alone, Kozlov took the pass. Did he have too much time? Should he have shot it right away? All the things that goal scorers will think about after the fact. He's going to watch it. You know what he's doing? He's watching himself right now on the replay. And what a stop by Tommy Salo. He went to the backhand. Salo had committed himself, but he did it right and makes a tremendous save to keep the score 1-0 for the Islanders. That's too much time. Good coverage in front of the net on Martin Lapointe, number 20.
Red Wings control the draw. Golubovsky had all he could do just to keep it in the Islanders' zone. A chance behind the net. Took a hit from Martin Lapointe. But the Islanders clear out, and Aaron Ward hustles back into his own zone for the Red Wings. Mariana lost it to Smolinski in center. Jenny Smolinski and Linden, the Islander forward line. Kozlov back at his own blue line now to Mariana. 2:45 gone in the second period. A chance for Ward, but his angle was almost nil. And Salo made the stop. Chara shovels one. Linden deflects. Janney carries in. Janney sets up Linden. Drives to the net. Backhands, regains the puck, and then put it off the side of the net.
Good defensive move by Larry Murphy again, Howie, and directly in front of Hodgson.
Here's Kozlov, hassled from behind by Smolinski. Larionov got it deep once again. Rost, number 23, was hit by Richter. And Sacco finds Brewer behind the Islander net. Now Brewer, head up, feeds the right side to Linden, and the Islanders attack. Sacco into the zone, trying to get around Murphy. Murphy took him down, and the Islanders will get a power play. So Sacco kept his legs moving, and Larry Murphy was forced to bring out the hook. The Islanders will try and add to their lead.
Willie.
It's go time.
Ah!
Hey.
That creepy mouse with the goggles is back in my apartment.
Really?
Can I hang here?
Absolutely.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
I used to be a car racer.
Oh, wow.
Come on.
Want to know how to make that old computer go faster?
Pretty fast.
The latest computers at the fastest speeds at Office Depot. Low prices every day.
Larry Murphy gets the hook for hooking. That's right, he's in the penalty box. Sacco with the puck. Fakes and goes outside. He kind of pushed him. Sacco kind of, he bailed out on him. He pulled the ripcord. He helped the referee make the decision.
Well, he gets a power play for the Islanders. Donato and Janssen have the points. Palfi, Reichel, Lawrence up front. Janssen thought about a shot. Now it's Palfi. Red Wings aggressive on the penalty kill. Puck comes through the slot, backed up by Reichel at the point. Natty Janssen and Reichel. One-timer. They score! Deflected in front. 2-0 Islanders.
Well, Donato had a stick in there. Palfi had his stick in there. One of the other Islanders, I believe, Mark Lawrence, had a stick in there. The puck ends up in the net. They don't care. It's a 2-0 lead. Back-to-back power play goals by the Islanders. And Robert Reichel, that shot from the point. Let's take a look. It changed direction. There's the shot by Reichel. Low, there's the sticks all jamming at the puck. You see it sliding into the corner to the left. Goal post, Ted Donato. Signaling it's in. Palfi signaling it's in. And Mark Lawrence saying, I agree with both of you. Watch from overhead. The puck is going to go into the right goal post. Here comes the shot. There it is. Boom.
I think Donato might have been in the crease, Eddie.
Oh, no.
They're reviewing it now.
I'm thinking more goals. I'm really slow now, aren't I?
Well, you know, if anything, it was a toenail, but I believe they're going to wave this off, and they do.
Whoa.
Donato, the next time you get a chance to look, had the tip of his skate in the goal crease.
I'm trying to figure out who got the goal. Never mind. Oh, wow. I'm rusty, folks. I apologize.
Oh, it's not you. Donato thought he had one, too. Watch
well,
his skate.
Watch again. Well, he's over here on the right side. Right there. His left skate in the... No, come on. They're not going to pull a goal back from that. Get rid of that replay.
Well, I tell you what, you're not the only one that feels that way, because there has been a lot of momentum built lately towards giving the referees on the ice, as it used to be, the discretion over calling the in-the-crease rule. Because, yes, Donato technically was in the crease, but on that play, it had no impact whatsoever on how the puck got into the net.
Was his foot on the line? You know, you could argue. Well, anyway. I'm not here to argue. I'm here to have fun.
I don't argue. That's part of the fun.
Okay. Get rid of that thing. The referee and the linesman. They used to make the call.
A minute 20 remains on the Larry Murphy penalty. So the Islanders lose the goal, but they're still on the power play. 1-0 New York. Janssen to Donato. And now Reichel almost clips the referee, Dave Jackson. Not his fault. It was video review that took the goal away. And Aaron Ward shovels it the other way to Lidstrom. Nick Lidstrom up the boards. Palfi cuts it off. Ran into his own man, Reichel. And then Ward runs into Palfi. And before it's all over, Yzerman fails to clear. So Palfi nudges it to the blue line to Janssen. A floater knocked down by Lidstrom. Palfi jumps on it. Palfi pulls up. Feeds the blue line. Donato to Reichel. Janssen now. Half minute to the power play. Palfi takes it off the boards. Sets up Reichel. Janssen draws a pair, so he moved it quickly, as does Reichel. But it comes back to Reichel at the blue line. Down the boards for Ziggy. Reichel put it off the skate of Yzerman. Wound around by Janssen. 8 seconds left to the power play. Palfi drifting back. Sets up Reichel. Long drive. Knocked down by Ward. Rebound. Score. This one will count. 2-0 New York.
That was one's gonna stick. Richter with a beautiful move down the left side of the ring. Power play, I believe, was over. I'm guessing, but I thought it was 8 seconds. You had mentioned, Howie, it seemed like a little more than 8 seconds. But a good move, a good shot. Watch him, he's gonna come down the ice from the top right area as Palfy controls the puck. He almost lost it here and he faked back. There's the pass, there's the shot, there's the rebound. Wow, with almost no room. Watch the goaltender's right leg. Kevin Hodgson, as he moved over, just enough room for the puck. And the Islanders, well, they regained the goal they lost moments ago. And Richter has made it 2-0.
Technically, it is not a power play goal, although Murphy had not been back into the play. So, in effect, the Islanders do score in a 5-on-4 situation. Just don't get credit for a power play goal, but what do they care? It's 2-0. The Islanders leading the defending Stanley Cup champions. Erickson back at the Detroit blue line. Now to Dandino. Laid off the boards on right wing by Holmstrom. Maltby from a sharp angle, denied by Cello. So it's Barry Richter with his sixth of the year. Set up by Reichel and Palfy at 5:36. Draper checked by Watt as the Red Wings have it in the Islanders zone. Barry Richter throwing his muscle around on Holmstrom. And then Maltby had been dropped by Brewer. Wojciechowski carries back the other way. A pass to Watt, who put it in front off of Hodgson. Watt then runs into Holmstrom behind the net, takes him down. There's going to be a penalty to Watt here. And the Islanders will be shorthanded this time.
It's like a roughing call, Howie. That's the time you have to be very careful. It's good to be aggressive. It's good to be skating. Good to be hitting. Play the body, but you've got to be smart about it. You can't get penalties in the offensive zone. This one's for roughing. You want to rough the guy up? Use your shoulder. Mike Watt takes a penalty. Important here that the Islanders kill this one off. And here was the play to the net. Islanders busy making things happen. See the hands up around the face? Roughing. Could have released it, let it go, gave it a little extra. Second effort. Draws a penalty.
So Bill Stewart said this morning he was going behind the bench tonight as much as a message to his team as anything else, resulting from yesterday's traffic accident where he suffered a concussion. He said, listen, if I can go out there and coach hurt, then these guys can go out there and give a little extra themselves. At least that was what Stewie had to say about it this morning. Now he'll watch his team defend against the Detroit power play.
When he played, Howie, he was an old-fashioned hockey player. He played hurt, and that's the way he coaches.
Lindstrom plays it to the Islander blue line. Islanders held the Red Wings without a shot on their first power play. That was funny listening to Stewie this morning. He said, listen, when I played, if I had a concussion, I usually went out and played anyway. So if I can play with a concussion, why can't I coach with one? Well, I suppose that's one way to look at it.
We used to say players like he and me, so on, we wouldn't have known if we had a concussion anyway. Headache was part of the deal. Now, I'll tell you what. This is enough to give anybody a headache when you look at the front of his one-time pretty red automobile. Explained how one of the vehicles that was involved in the construction, the Wantagh Parkway, pulled out, and he couldn't avoid it.
You know what ticks him off, among many things about the accident? The airbag never deployed.
Some of those stories we hear about airbags, maybe it's better. He might have been hurt worse.
Larionov for Lidstrom as the Red Wings carry into the Islanders zone. Detroit on the power play with 1:10 remaining to the man advantage. Larionov, Lidstrom, now to Yzerman. Oh, LaPointe got a stick on that pass. Lidstrom gets it back. Kozlov, LaPointe, Larionov, Yzerman, and Lidstrom form the five-man power play unit for the Red Wings. Pilon and Janssen, the D. Linden and Claude LaPointe up front. This is Pilon, around but not out. Lidstrom to Yzerman. Down low, Kozlov put it off of Larionov, gets it back, and curls it behind the net.
That was a good stop by Salo. How he stacked his pass going to his left and made that save, and another penalty coming up.
Pilon took down LaPointe. That was the first call, but Pilon even things up now.
Yeah, I think Detroit's going to get a penalty here. They're arguing it pretty strongly. It's a cross-checking penalty. Emphatic quickly demonstrated by referee Dave Jackson. Pilon goes in. So does LaPointe. Woo, there's the first one. And now LaPointe says, take that. You know, Pilon dumped on him. He did. He went down knowing that Pilon knew he was getting a penalty. So he did a smart thing. He took a bit of a dive, emphasizing the cross check by LaPointe, which makes LaPointe that much madder.
So what could have been a Detroit 5-on-3 for 29 seconds will now simply be, as it was scheduled, a 5-on-4, as those secondary penalties to Pilon and LaPointe will not affect the on-ice manpower. The dual cross-check calls come at 7:53 here in the second period. Fedorov wins the draw. Murphy twisted behind the net. Sallow just took a little bump, but Holmstrom, who was moving by. And now Holmstrom has it go past him to the other side of the ice. Chara checked by Holmstrom, but Chara keeps going and sends it out of the zone.
Good play by Zdeno Chara. Good pursuit of the puck, Howie. He could see it in there, and he didn't back off. He kept going. Confidence.
Holmstrom for Murphy. Into the Islander zone. Quick shot, juggle, and finally grabbed by Sallow. And Chara trying to keep Holmstrom away from Tommy Sallow's neighborhood. That came just at the conclusion of the Detroit power play, so the Islanders, for the second time tonight, have taken care of the Red Wings. When Detroit's had the man advantage, will step out. Midway through the second, Islanders lead.
The spirit of competition between the Nissan Maxima and the Nissan Pathfinder runs deep. With an engine called simply the best V6 available in America, the Maxima is New York's best-selling V6 sedan. The Pathfinder is New York's best-selling import SUV, so their competition is no surprise. Every family has a little sibling rivalry. Lease a Maxima SE or Pathfinder XE for $299 a month for 39 months with a $999 initial payment.
The future of sports journalism in America? You're looking at it. Overly dramatic lighting.
NHL powers collide on Fox Sports New York. Sunday, it's a matinee at the Meadowlands as the Devils go head-to-head with Keith Tkachuk and the Cup contenders from Phoenix. Devils and Coyotes, Sunday at 12.
Well, that's Chris Osgood. What's he looking up at? He's been entertained by the board here. And last night, he was part of the entertainment. One of the most exciting things in sports, Pavel Bure. Well, anybody on a penalty shot. Boy, does he bury that under the net. Lifted the net right off the ice. Pavel Bure back, and the Panthers are happy.
That was actually one of two penalty shots taken in the NHL last night. There have only been 20 all year. 10% of them came last night. Todd White of the Blackhawks was unsuccessful against Jamie Storr of the Los Angeles Kings in a game the Kings won 2-1.
I had it for you, Howie, just in case.
Attaboy, 18. LaPointe of the Islanders. Checked by Holmstrom of the Red Wings. LaPointe gets it back before giving it away to Brown.
That was deflected, Howie. He saw Chara open and he knew he could get it to him. It was deflected on its way.
Holmstrom tried to set up Fedorov, who was ridden away from the puck by Chara. And Claude LaPointe with the Red Wings changing. Fires one. Kicked out by Hodgson. Dandenault wheels it back behind the net to Anders Ericsson. Islanders have now outshot the Red Wings 19-13. They have a 2-0 lead. Maltby on Brewer. Went off of Sallow's glove, and Palfy has it for New York. Almost lost it to Maltby. Palfy finally went down, so Draper back up, and he's checked immediately by Barry Richter. Help for Detroit comes from McCarty. He spun it in front. Brewer's there. Played it off the boards, and this one headed all the way down. Maybe an icing, and there will be, as Lidstrom wins the race. So as long as penalty shots seem to be the story of the day, or at least the moment, that gives us an opening for Vice President of Trivia Jay Altmaier's offering for tonight's Dodge Trivia Quiz. First Islander to score on a penalty shot. February 1st, 70. Was it you? Come on, you can eliminate yourself if it's no.
I'm not. No, it wasn't
all
me.
All right. You ever score on a penalty shot?
No, but I can tell you a story about a penalty shot. We had a lot of unsuccessful penalty shots my last year at junior hockey. And at that time, you could appoint whoever you wanted to take the penalty shot. I said to the coach, we got a penalty shot. Give it to me. I'll put that thing in.
Yeah, and?
Didn't know. That was the last time I was ever appointed to take a penalty shot.
You must have been awfully secure, though, because you did go from juniors to the NHL when there were 100 players in the whole league in 16.
Not on my penalty shot prowess.
So you never took one in the NHL at all?
No.
Pavel Bure's already had 10.
Yeah, he would. No, he's at 5. Five. He scored 5 on 7 attempts.
I thought he was in 7. Double digits. I don't know if I'm counting the All-Star game and the finals in there.
If he's, yeah, he's had 9 then, I guess. 5 on 7 would be 9. 2 he missed.
So that's 7. Reichel behind the net. Eddie, it's my arithmetic that's off. Don't cover up. Donato in the corner. Try to get it back down low, but it's Lidstrom breaking it up for the Red Wings. And now McCarty lost it to Brewer. Good work there by Eric Brewer. And nifty pass up the left side by Palfy to Donato. Smolinski with Palfy breaking to the net, couldn't hold the puck.
And he knew he was there, Howie. Had just a good poke check at the last minute by Detroit.
Kenny Janssen dribbles one ahead and gets it back. Now a chance for Smolinski that went behind Linden. And then Rost put it off at Islander skate. A chance chased by Larionov. Rost in there as well. Larionov behind the net. Smolinski in on him. Well, Lebovsky pinch got it behind the net, but now Lachance takes over for the Islanders. Scott Lachance ices the puck. Well, Lebovsky back to touch up. 8:43 remaining in the second period. The Islanders have scored twice, both here in period number 2, and lead the champs.
And whoever said less is more? Hey, more is more. You get more.
VIP, America's number one new action show, wants to get your motor running. Watch VIP every weekend and enter the VIP Get Your Motor Running sweepstakes. You could win a cool new 1999 Mazda Miata 10th Anniversary Edition. For details, pick up the February 12th or February 22nd issue of Sports Illustrated or log on to www.vipsweepstakes.com. Get your motor running with VIP and Mazda today. Check your local listings for time and station.
All right, let's clean it up. The answer to our Dodge trivia quiz, I guess Billy Harris.
I thought it was Jermaine Gagne, but it was not. It was, yes, our assistant coach, Lorne Henry.
Hey, I got to tell you, I got quite a kick out of listening to you, Lorne, and Clark Gillies, and Jean Potvin, and Bobby Nystrom during that roundtable we did.
There's a few segments from that roundtable. Stu Wiener, who produced that show, we could have gone for another 2 hours, but... That's amazing.
I heard you did.
Well, that was after they put the cameras away and the mic.
Well, we'll run more snippets from that great little panel discussion on future editions of Geico Game Night prior to our telecasts of Islander games. Sergei Nemchinov for the Islanders now. Into the Detroit zone, but Lawrence had been knocked down and had no way to get out.
Well, you get that collection around a microphone and camera, and all they need is just a little hint, and away they go.
So Pat Price really did break
yes.
the egg on Al Harvey's head.
It Clark Gillies was going to do it, and I took an egg. I mean, Al was trying. You know, he came up with all these ideas, and he was trying to make a point.
Wait a minute.
Oh, we got time for this.
Here we are in the middle of a great story, and
Ab DeMarco, Kevin, Butler, John Davidson, Kevin Meininger. Let's see, he was a right winger.
Yeah. And he was so good a right winger, he wound up in the truck.
Yeah.
As the producer, our esteemed,
yes.
erstwhile, beloved producer, Fedorov, a shot. Solo grabs that. It's still loose. Iserman hits the side of the net. Rebound missed by Dandenault. Holy smokes, you mentioned Meininger's name, and everything breaks loose.
Well, just action. That's what Meininger's all about, is action. And what a job again by Tommy Salo.
I was going to mention emotionally how he's leaving us after tonight, but now he's going to want to roll in the replay.
Yeah.
So we can't do that.
Yeah. Well, he'll take that tape home with him. But what a job Tommy Salo has been doing in this hockey game as well. Fedorov, I mean, point blank range. There it is. Beautiful stop. As Salo makes the save, spreads out that rebound attempt on the ice by Fedorov on the outside of the net. But the initial save, Tommy Salo. Wow. The concentration. Now, a lot of people ask me also about him because I have always been a big fan of Tommy Salo. I like the way he handles himself. And I go back to the last 2 years. I suppose this year is going to be the same. Trying to make the playoffs, the last run, coaches go to him and say, you're the man, you got to play. And he's done a great job.
Martin LaPointe of the Red Wings. Brian Smolinski, Trevor Linden tried to come to his defense, and now Chara does. That's Ward of Detroit going at Chara.
Ward punching Chara in the back of the head.
And now Linden wants Ward. Trevor Linden acting every bit the captain here. Brian Smolinski really appeared to be shaken momentarily. And he's checking for blood. And everybody appears to be all right. We'll see what Dave Jackson does about this. Now Chara is in the box for going at Ward. We'll see if anything else is coming up. Martin LaPointe's going in for Detroit.
It'll be interesting to see what the call will be, whether or not the stick into the face. I don't know whether he got the stick into the face or punched Brian Smolinski, but anyway, there was an exchange. Good hit there. Trevor Linden. And then LaPointe goes in, and there LaPointe and Smolinski. It looked like LaPointe wanted to go after Trevor Linden. And now, look at here. Better almost get on a stepladder to push him in the back of the head. Look at Ward. Now, does Ward get a penalty for punching Chara twice in the back of the head? I guess not. That was the initial play. That was a good hit by Trevor Linder. Finished the check. Someone said it was after the whistle, and who cares? He still finished his check.
But Martin LaPointe and Zdeno Chara wind up with the penalty box. The Islanders will get a power. Will the Islanders get a power play out of this?
Depends on what LaPointe gets.
Bill Stewart certainly thinks so.
Smolinski. 2 minutes each, according to the board. So Bill Stewart's asking one of the linesmen.
Well, it looked like the stick from LaPointe ended up getting Smolinski between the legs. And then another stick came up on him. And the one that they're calling here is the high stick.
That's Detroit's number 20, LaPointe. 2 minutes for high sticking.
The high stick, you saw Smolinski earlier checking his forehead. That's the one that drew the ire of Dave Jackson and the rest of the Islanders. Chara also goes for roughing. And they're only getting one of them. So it's going to be a 4-on-4 situation.
I guess the referee didn't see it, but it may have not been serious enough anyway. So, and a lot of times it depends. You can see his face is a little red. Looks like he might have got a stick into the face.
So it stays at four aside. Larionov, Kozlov, Lidstrom, and Dandenault for Detroit. Claude LaPointe with Smolinski up front. Richter and Lachance are the Islander defense pair. Now Smolinski, a natural centerman, will come in and take the draw rather than LaPointe, who gets tossed. Scott Lachance in the corner. Played it to the opposite side of the ice. And gets it back from LaPointe. So a little extra ice to work with here. Fired hard around by Lachance. And it's Kozlov leaving it in the corner for Lidstrom. Arianov. This crossing with Dandino carries in, leaves it for Lidstrom. Long drive, stick save, and a rebound. And it's Kozlov taking it into the corner. Smolinski got him first, then it was Richter. And that's how the Islanders gain control of the puck. Barry Richter, who has the second goal. Islanders with a 2-0 lead here, just under 7 minutes remaining in the second period. Matthew Dandino behind the net. Talked about how studious he's been before, learning to play defense in this league, a natural forward. He spent a lot of time watching Larry Murphy and Nicklas Lidström, and one of the things he was saying he's really learned from them, patience, how long to hold on to the puck. Yzerman held on to it just long enough there to get a good shot off the Sellers.
Such a dangerous player, Howie, offensively, defensively. When I look at him and his career and what he does for his hockey team, it reminds me so much of Brian Trotche and what he did with the Islanders. And just a dangerous player with the puck offensively, so good defensively. Look at him wait, talk about patience. He waits at the right time and then fires it, gets it on the net. Doesn't let Rich Pilon break it up with a stick check. See most career goals with one team. Second to Mario Lemieux. Mario Lemieux going to have, and there's of course Bossy, all of the Islanders, and Richard from Montreal, Stan Mikita. We'll talk about Mario Lemieux having a golf tournament each summer in Pittsburgh. Mikita has one in Chicago.
And I'm sure you've played in both of them. You know, you mentioned Steve Yzerman wearing number 19. He does that in tribute to Brian Trotche, who is his boyhood hero. Yzerman drafted in 1983 by the Red Wings. Same year, the Islanders won their fourth consecutive Stanley Cup. And in that draft, the Islanders came away with a fellow named Pat LaFontaine.
And Pat Flatley.
That's right. Murphy centered one. It deflected off of Reichel. That's a pretty shifty maneuvering by Bill Torrey. Could he trade Bob Lorimer to Colorado, I think, for the draft pick that turned out to be Pat LaFontaine? Actually, that may be the second shiftiest move of all time. Sam Pollock, general manager of the Montreal Canadiens, knew that he had the Oakland Seals pick the year that Guy Lafleur was coming out of juniors.
And you know who he got it from? Bill Torrey.
When Torrey was running the Seals. But what Pollock did was, when the LA Kings started to struggle and threatened the Seals as the worst team in the league, he said, wait a minute, I don't have the Kings pick, so I'm going to basically give them somebody to make them better. And he sent them Ralph Backstrom.
Backstrom, exactly.
Doug Brown centers. He scores. He was looking for Holmstrom. It never reached Holmstrom. But it found its way past Salo, and the Red Wings are on the board. It's now 2-1 New York.
Well, that's a tough break for the Islanders. Tommy Salo, he gets left alone. Now he's walking out as if they want to go to review. Referee talks to linesman. Linesman says that's pretty close. Maybe we ought to do it. Salo is up at the blue line. There you see him looking at the officials as they talk it over. And if there's a hesitation, Howie, that means that there must be a question. If there's a question, then they're going to go upstairs.
It might be a kick. Dave Jackson immediately pointed to center ice, so I don't know that this is going upstairs. Remember, that puck came across the ice intended for Holmstrom.
Well, we'll take a look. Fake shot. The Islanders get caught. Whoa, he did have his feet out there. Did it accidentally hit them? And were they in the crease?
There's a couple of things you wonder about there. Did he make a distinct kicking motion, and did he get to the crease before the puck did?
Ooh, that's so close, isn't it? It looked like it was off his stick there, but it looked like at the other replay it was off his skates, which you could say he was being checked at the time. He was falling and his skates moved forward. You know, you can do that as a hockey player. And you know what? You could never call it as a deliberate kick in. As long as there's a defending player in contact with you, you kind of slide like you're going into second base gently, knowing that that's where the puck's coming. And let's take another look from overhead. Watch on the right side of Tommy Salo. The puck will come across from left to right there. There's stick. Yeah, it was stick. Yeah, he went in after. No, there's no question it counts. Islanders lead now cut in half.
Brendan Shanahan had immediately gone to the referee, Dave Jackson, motioning with his stick to say, hey, wait a minute, he got that with his stick, not his skate. The Islander protest had to do with whether or not that puck might have been kicked in, but clearly, great piece of work by our camera people once again, those last two replays, showing you that it was stick, and he did not get to the crease early. So the goal stands 2-1. And a penalty coming up here to the Islanders. Centering feed broken up finally as it went off the skate of Holmstrom and came to Salo.
Must be a slashing penalty, Howie. I see a broken stick out there on the ice. LaPointe is without a stick.
Well, I'll tell you what, I thought at first that puck never reached Holmstrom, but a great job by Holmstrom to get the Red Wings on the board.
Come on. Come on, he's taking too long. I should have gone.
Yeah, he should have gone, man. He should have gone.
Stow it. He's coming, and he's got him.
This is all I could get.
You did good, Billy. You did real good.
I should have planted that 3 hours ago.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Can I go now?
No!
I thought you were starting to go gray.
I was, but I never did.
So what happened, the miracle?
You can't tell?
Tell what?
I use Just for Men.
That's hair color?
Even your barber can't tell you use the hair coloring called Just for Men. Simply shampoo in, then rinse. In only 5 minutes, this unique Just for Men formula blends away the gray, actually matches your gray to your real color.
I never would have guessed.
Just for Men. So natural, even your barber can't tell.
Claude LaPointe needs a new hockey stick, and if you're wondering why, well, it's a slash. Boom, right there across the arms. See the stick down on the ice? Could be two penalties if you don't drop it. There's LaPointe, swings over. And then whack. You know, those sticks break easy, those kind that, you know, you have the blades and into the metal shaft.
You know what? You got to give Fedorov a little credit there, too, because a lot of times players try to over-dramatize a slash like that, but he had the puck near the Islanders' net, shrugged it off.
He's looking more to make a play to set up another goal, Howie. Another big kill here for the Islanders, just under five, about 4.5 minutes remaining here in the second period. Islanders' lead cut in half just moments ago. Holmstrom, getting his ninth to make it 2-1.
Yzerman through center. Looking skip away from Janssen. Great play by Janssen. Sacco follows. Long drive sticked aside by Kevin Hodgson, the Detroit goaltender. Martin LaPointe. Igor Larionov. Nick Lidstrom. Steve Yzerman. Vyacheslav Kozlov. The Detroit power play. This is Yzerman twisting it around behind the Islander net. Comes to the near board. Sacco tried to clear, did so. Got it past Lidstrom, who's trying to hold him off. Sacco was hoping for a penalty call there, but Martin LaPointe of Detroit back on the puck. And now the puck sent into the New York zone. Watt steps into Kozlov. The puck dribbles loose. Watt gets up to play it and sends it all the way down. 54 to go to the Detroit power play. Red Wings changing. And Doug Brown curls in his own zone, away from Linden. Linden just fell down, so now Brown with plenty of room into the Islanders' zone. Drops for Shanahan. Deflects to Fedorov. He shoots one. The carom behind Salo. Kept in by Murphy. His shot knocked down by Salo and finally cleared. And the Red Wings can't get much closer than they did on that deflected puck.
Good opportunity for Detroit. Ami Salo says, no, 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 Fedorov. You have done enough damage around this league. Not tonight. Not so far, anyway. Take a look. Doug Brown, he led the rush. There's the shot deflected there. Fedorov tries to go up top. Salo got a piece of it. Look at it roll across his shoulder. Thing stayed out. Way it's supposed to be in the eyes of Tommy Salo. Fedorov tried to beat him on the short side over his shoulder.
Tommy Salo fortunate there, too. A lot of times that puck will simply carry him right off the back and into the net. This time it rolled into the goal crease, and the Islanders were able to clear.
Well, so many times, Howie, motions by goaltenders in the net will create that. They'll push it back in. They put it in themselves. You see them, they kind of freeze. They don't want to make a motion. They can feel it tickling along their shoulders sometimes and across their back.
Gary Murphy chased by Watt. 10 seconds remaining to the Detroit power play, their third. Islanders have held them off the board with a man advantage tonight. And it's slapped down the ice by Janssen, so they'll do so here as well. Claude LaPointe up and out of the box. And the Islanders have killed the time for the third time tonight. Sigmund Palfi wields it into the Detroit end of the ice with 2:28 to go in the second period. Pandino just holding on behind the Detroit goal. Played it up the middle. Richter cut it off, but then the Islanders offside on the play with 2:14 left.
Big kill for the Islanders, Howie.
Gives them a lift. I hope it does. I mean, I always say that. I had said that for the last few years. There's things that happen in hockey games that you look for to get a boost from. And in an important game like this, and it's important because the Islanders want to do well. They want to get a nice crowd here tonight. They played well in the first period. They played well in the second period. They're leading 2-1. So you look at, okay, Detroit scores a goal. Don't let them tie this hockey game up before the period ends. Play well. Kill it off. Everybody on the bench knows it. So they should get a lift out of it.
Anders Ericsson into the Islanders zone, but Draper on left wing was ahead of the play and offside with 2:04 to go in the second period. After which we'll present our New York City Marriott Hotel's intermission report. We expect to chat with Darren McCarty of the Detroit Red Wings, as well as get you back to sports desk for another update from Deb Kaufman. And Eddie and I will have second period highlights. This is the period where all three goals have been scored. Got to ask McCarty about some, well, actually, we did talk to him in Detroit about it, now that I think of it. Here's a guy who's, we talked about his role as a mucker, not looked on to score a whole lot of goals. Does have 14 this year, but he scores some pretty goals as well as he did 2 years ago in the Stanley Cup Finals in the clinching game, and he had a gorgeous one against the Islanders earlier this month. Draper tried to throw it at the net. That was broken up by Richter. Up comes Palfi. Pulled down is Reichel, and it was not spotted. No penalty call. Reichel for Donato. He shoots. Kick save made. Rebound Reichel. And that's stopped by Hodgson. And the Islanders are somewhat hot on their bench as they had come into the Detroit zone. Looked like Reichel had been tripped up, headed to the net. Nothing was called.
Oh, yeah, Howie. That was a penalty. There's no question about it. Just away from the play. Reichel trying to break the check, trying to stay ahead of his back-checking Detroit player. Got out in front of him. It's pulled down. Look at on the ground, just going across the blue line. Did the referee think that he took a dive? If that's the case, give him a penalty for delay of hockey game. But then Reichel does get a scoring opportunity. Gets another one after that. You see him down in front of the net, pushing, shoving, and he is a little upset. But there's Reichel. He's out in front of his check. Look at this. Talk about a restraining foul going through the center ice area. Draper just grabbed onto him and went for a ride. Thought that was the things they were trying to get out of this game. Did I read somewhere that it seemed to be creeping back in the eyes of some of the general managers? Well, that was a good example.
Robert Reichel a little frustrated over the non-call, but Lidstrom carries to center for the Red Wings. Minute 23 to go in the second. Kozlov looking to split through, got a floater off. And Wells took a hit from Martin LaPointe. LaPointe back around in the corner. LaChance for the Islanders. And the whistle. 1:08 to go in the second period. The Islanders will be back here at the Nassau Coliseum to face the Ottawa Senators. That'll be on Tuesday, and that game will be available on tape delay. That's Tuesday at midnight on Fox Sports New York. The Islanders and the Ottawa Senators from the Nassau Coliseum.
Ottawa, wow, what a season they're having. Montreal beating them right now in the second period, 2-0.
Boy, Trevor Linden's name was all over the Ottawa papers today.
Really?
Yeah, in terms of trade rumors up there, the Senators not convinced that Vinny Prospo is going to be number two center for them over the long haul, at least in the playoffs, and so they may be looking to upgrade there, and Linden's name has been widely bandied about in Ottawa.
Were you talking about the fact that Brian Burke may be looking to try and get him back?
Yeah, Stan and Matty were discussing that between periods. Hemchinov. Around behind the net, Shanahan sends Lidstrom to center. Yzerman carries in, fires one, and it's gloved by Salo. 35.7 remaining in the period.
Well, the Islanders don't want to make that mistake, Harry. The last couple of good scoring opportunities have been on Tommy Salo. They don't want to let up now. 35 seconds remaining. They can go in feeling very good about themselves, winning the first period, giving up only one goal in the second, having some good scoring chances themselves. And Yzerman, ooh. Whenever you go down like that with a player like Yzerman, as Rich Pilon slides down, taking away the low ice, you know he's going high. So does Tommy Salo. That's the only place he has to worry about is high then. Pilon's got the low ice covered.
Heiserman's 2 points behind Ron Francis. 14-67 for not only Heiserman, but the great Stan Mikita. And Ron Francis, now the Carolina Hurricanes, who were shut out 1-0 by Vancouver last night. 2 points ahead of Mikita and Heiserman. Out from behind, tried to come Nemchinov. Took a glove in the face from Dandenault. 14 seconds left in the period. The puck pinned in the corner. And Dave Jackson finally blows play down with 9 seconds to go. And nothing serious will develop from this.
Well, the Islanders are back in the offensive zone now. 9 seconds remaining. That's where they want to be. They want to make sure that the puck ticks down at the expense of the Detroit Red Wings. On the point. He knows all about those little parts of the hockey game. He's generally out there. End of period, particularly if the Islanders have the lead.
So Robert Reichel out with Linden, Richter, Halfy, and Janssen for the faceoff deep in the Detroit zone. The Red Wings have Chris Draper set to take the draw. Larry Murphy on defense along with Lidstrom. Cartier Maltby, the other Detroit forwards. Draper drew it back. Murphy spins it around the boards, and the period will end here. Draper being tugged at by Linden. The Islanders will take a one-goal lead into the room, leading 2-1.
Well, they have to feel good about that. They had a pretty good second period. Match the first period. Heading off the ice, Draper. Holmstrom got the only goal for the Detroit Red Wings. There he is, number 96, as he heads off the ice. A very entertaining game so far through a couple of periods.
Islanders got the first two, technically the first three, one call back by video review, although really they came in the same power play sequence, even though by the time Barry Richter became the second entry in our Marriott scoring summary, penalty had just expired just a second before. So it's not a power play goal. Reichel's clearly was. That was in the first minute of the period. And then Holmstrom redirected the pass from Brown. Fedorov drawing the second assist. Islanders were outshot 13-8 in the second period. Have a 23-23 tie in that department. But where it counts, on the board, it's the Islanders 2 and the Detroit Red Wings 1. Our second intermission activities will begin from the Coliseum right after these messages.
UPS Flight 240, this is Air Traffic Control. We got a customer call for a pickup at 350 Main, Suite 200.
Roger that, Control. We're on our way.
For on-call air pickup service and guaranteed delivery, call 1-800-PICK-UPS.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah, yeah.
How come you're always raking it in?
The secret of my success is keeping a clean cab and telling people to dial 1010-220.
What?
Yeah. All calls up to 20 minutes are only 99 cents all day, every day.
99 cents? I find more than that in the seats. Well, what if I talk over 20 minutes?
Just 10 cents for each extra minute.
Do you mind if I tell people about this 1010-220?
Go get him, Tiger.
Yeah.
Rookies.
Dial 1010-220.
Am I on? Geico Direct could save you hundreds of dollars on car insurance. Result?
Smaller bill.
Geico, a 15-minute call could save you 15% or more. At Geico, we get the ball rolling on your claim quickly. Even in the middle of the night. Geico, a 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Ford, built for the way you live.
Whether you like to hit the trails or check out the big city, you'll want to get to the President's Day sales event at your Tri-State Quality Ford store today. And check out the great deals on Ford Explorer. Now get a $299 a month lease on the Go Anywhere, Do Anything Ford Explorer Sport. Or get 1.9 financing on every new 99 Explorer in stock. Hurry into the President's Day sales event going on now.
Really? You bet I can get there.
Visit your Tri-State Quality Ford store.
For high-speed express service to Europe, call 1-800-PICK-UPS.
Long Island's hometown team is back. Great tickets to the Saints' next home game are on sale now. Saints fans, get ready for more scoring.
Bring it on.
More hitting.
Bring it on.
More action.
Bring it on.
The Saints take on the Syracuse Smash in indoor lacrosse superstar Paul Gates. Catch the action 1:30 this Sunday. Bring the kids for a great afternoon of family fun. Great tickets are on sale at the Nassau Coliseum box office and Ticketmaster. And kids' tickets start at just $6. Get ready for New York Saints lacrosse action. Hometown team. Hometown pride.
Welcome back to the Nassau Coliseum. The Islanders on top of Detroit by a score of 2-1. I'm joined by the Red Wings' Darren McCarty. And Darren, what did you think about that second period? Who had the edge?
Well, I think we put a lot of shots on them. We had some power play opportunities, but they capitalized on their power play chances. And to get behind 2-0 in here is tough, but we've battled back, and the goal we got near the end of the period is big for us. So we got to regroup and come out and play a strong third period.
It's been a brilliant month for the Red Wings, 7-3-3. It wraps up tonight. And yet this last week, somewhat spinning your wheels, giving up some third period leads. Any particular reason?
It's mentally more than anything. We've done some things uncharacteristic past three games. We go from winning six straight and possibly being on a nine-game winning streak, and we're winless in three now because we've given up two goal leads and a three goal lead last night to Florida. So this is something that maybe this will get us going back in the right direction. We got to come from behind.
Now let's talk a little bit about your charitable efforts. I know that you and Chris Draper have candy bars named after you, and I understand the sales are going pretty well in the Detroit area.
Yeah, they're going really well. It's sponsored by Morley's Chocolate, and the proceeds go to the McCarty Cancer Foundation. I set up for my dad, who's got multiple myeloma cancer. So we sold a lot of bars and all the hockey organizations and kids in the area, and people are selling fundraising for their organizations, and we're getting some money for ours too. So it's been great.
All right, well, I got to ask you, who's selling better, Draper's or yours?
Well, mine has pecans, so it's aimed at older, and he likes to, for the school-age kids, his is like a Mars bar, so he says he sells more, but mine tastes better.
All right, fair enough. Darren, we appreciate your time. We have reached the second intermission. It is the Islanders on top of the Red Wings by a score of 2-1. After this break, we're going to go to the sports desk for an update in the world of sports.
Hello.
Hello. I just enrolled my company in this healthcare plan, and I need some information on a small procedure.
Oh, fine. Just wait a moment, and we can call Debbie at Central.
Debbie? Who's Debbie? My doctor's not Debbie.
You love Debbie. Debbie's at your healthcare company. She's in charge of your health.
Is she a doctor?
No, but she's really nice. She was a cheerleader. And as long as Debbie's been at your healthcare company, no one here has ever missed a birthday card.
I want my doctor.
Well, we could just ask Debbie.
Is your business healthcare plan all that it should be? Or is Debbie making important decisions about your healthcare? With HIP coverage, only doctors make healthcare decisions. HIP has added thousands of doctors in private practice to its participating network and offers the lowest priced healthcare option of any major plan with comparable benefits in Metro New York. If you're in charge of your company's healthcare benefits, call your broker or HIP and you'll receive a free brochure and a 10-minute prepaid long distance calling card. Find out why so many are switching to HIP, where business should be. So where do you get your health care?
It's HIP.
During the Lincoln President's Day sale, remember this historic figure. $499. That's a $499 monthly lease for your choice. Lincoln Town Car with all-speed traction control or the front-wheel drive Lincoln Continental. Two of America's greatest leaders in luxury. See your Lincoln dealer today. Because after all, nobody knows more about President's Day sales than Lincoln. What a luxury car should be.
They made the game what it is. Today, as we retire 52,
53, and 54,
we ask, will the game ever be the same?
It'll be better.
New York Lotto. With fewer numbers, it's going to be more winnable than ever. Plus more prize levels. And match just three numbers, you win. New Lotto. The game will never be the same.
New York Islanders hockey on Fox Sports New York is brought to you in part by the New York Lottery. Play New York games because, hey, you never know.
The Islanders and Red Wings are through two, and the Islanders are leading it 2-1. I'm Deb Kaufman back at the MSG Sports Desk. The Panthers and Maple Leafs are at the Air Canada Center in Toronto. Considering this game was scoreless after one, it's now 3-1. Toronto had a 3-0 lead. Mike Johnson's 18th made it 2-0, and Todd Warner's 8th made it 3-0. He was waiting. Nice shot. The Panthers got one back, but they're still down 3-1. In Montreal, the Senators and Canadiens are through the second period. Mark Recchi with his 12th of the year with about 2 minutes left in the first put Montreal on top 1-0. Again, it's now 2-0. So Recchi scored the first. Vladimir Malakhov scoring the second like he was on the ice by himself, driving through the defenseman. He punches it in, a nice-looking effort, giving Montreal a two-goal cushion. Earlier today, Boston avoided overtime with a Jason Allison goal late in the third. They edged the Capitals 4-3. They got three power play goals in the game. The Rangers shut out the Coyotes last night against Phoenix, their first game without Wayne Gretzky, but they will be in Pittsburgh tomorrow afternoon to take on the Penguins. They're off tonight. NBA tonight, the Nets are playing like it's a must-win for them. They're off to that 2-9 start. They were all over the Celtics from the opening tip, but Boston is now back in the game. It's 45-42 at halftime. Kerry Kittles and Keith Van Horn each have 9. Rutgers might have cost themselves a trip to the NCAA tournament. It's not over for them yet, but they lost to Miami today in their regular season finale. And Villanova probably played themselves into the tournament. They got their 20th win, upsetting number 7 St. John's. We're back for the third period of the Islander game right after this.
New York Islanders hockey on Fox Sports New York is brought to you in part by New Discover Platinum. Now more than ever, it pays to discover platinum. And by The Wiz, your ticket to entertainment.
I'm going to go look at stereos.
Every time we're here, you look at stereos. Then you test them, then you listen to them. Why don't you ever just buy one? They've got Sony, Iowa, Yamaha. The prices are the lowest you've ever seen. You're never going to find anything better. Just get one. Do it. Buy it. Commit.
You know nothing about men, do you?
We have enough name-brand audio equipment to keep you fooling around for years. Only at The Wiz, your ticket to entertainment.
You know, we've been together for a while, and I've been thinking. I don't know, I'm missing something from our relationship. I think it's just best if we make a clean break.
Expect more from your credit card. Introducing Discover Platinum. With a new low rate and a cashback bonus award, it pays to discover. Platinum. Call 1-800-DISCOVER.
Check, please. Oh, you'll get this right.
Dodge Dakota, Dodge Ram, add more muscle, in a hurry.
This should be an interesting third period. The Islanders scored the first two goals of the game, each early in the second period. The Red Wings got one late. Should be an interesting contrast in styles, too, huh?
Oh, yeah. But I think that the Islanders are doing, Howie, they're just playing out flat. They're just not flat hockey, but they're just working hard, and it seems to be paying off. They're covering a lot of ice. And what happens, too, is a lot of times you cover up for a lot of mistakes. Tommy Salo's covered the rest.
Well, let's take a look at the highlights of the second period. They're brought to you by New York City Marriott Hotels. The Islanders got the first one on the power play.
Well, it was a too many men on the ice penalty at the end of the first period. And here's Zygmunt Palfy with his beautiful pass timed just right. And Robert Rykall is 18th on a power play, just 47 seconds into the second period. And that again, little chip shot, Palfy, Rykall. There's the shot, and moving down the boards, Richter. Beautiful shot. Just enough room for the puck. He doesn't care. It's a 2-0 lead. That's after a goal had been called back on the Islanders. Bit of a letdown. This is the no goal that the Islanders had scored. Excuse me. This is the goal. Playoff's going to come and develop down in Detroit's end of the ice and then into the center ice. That long pass to the right side. And Doug Brown moving in, fakes, holds it, and then timed it perfectly. Holmstrand through the goal crease, and it was 2-1.
Each side with 23 shots, so we're set up for what should be a good third period with the Islanders leading.
Sorry. Not enough. No, still short.
For the great taste that will fill you up and never let you down.
Paper or plastic?
Paper.
Make it a Bud Light.
Guys, need a receipt?
Overtime. That's what your motor oil's doing up to 3,000 miles of severe driving, okay? As you put off changing it until your protection's as bad as a bunch of figure skaters defending the goal.
Talk about engine abuse.
That's why there's reformulated Quaker State for protection beyond 3,000 miles under any driving conditions. It's been tested, and unlike them, it works. How's that for overtime insurance?
Reformulated Quaker State for protection beyond 3,000 miles. Now available at Aid Auto Stores.
You're so lucky. Not one gray hair.
When a woman can run her fingers through your hair and can't tell you blend away your gray, that's a natural-looking result. And that's just what you get with the hair color called Just for Men. Simply shampoo in, then rinse. In only 5 minutes, this unique formula blends away gray, actually matches your gray to your real color. So nobody knows, even close up.
I just love your hair.
Just for Men. It looks so natural, even she can't tell.
Get excited next time you get behind the wheel. Get into the 99 Pontiac Grand Prix GT sedan with wide track performance, V6, and a $306 per month GMAC smart lease with just $306 due at lease signing. Or the redesigned Grand Am sedan, solid unibody construction, twin cam engine, lease for $229 a month with zero money due at lease signing. See your Tri-State Pontiac dealer by March 1st. Hurry.
We sell excitement.
It's coming to the Nassau Coliseum for its only New York appearance.
It's the award-winning International Championship Rodeo.
Featuring six exciting contest events, plus camel racing,
wild and wacky ostrich racing,
dancing horses, daring comedy bullfighters,
plus the Western harmonies of the Sons of Tennessee.
You've seen it on TV, now see it live. Don't miss all the thrills, chills, and spills April 16th through the 18th at the Nassau Coliseum.
Join the fun. Get tickets now
at the Nassau Coliseum and Ticketmaster.
Or charge by phone.
Steve Webb of the Islanders is going to lead his teammates at their annual bowl-a-thon, which benefits Big Brothers Big Sisters. It's scheduled for tomorrow at the Sheridan Lanes in Mineola. Fans of all ages invited to attend and bowl for kids' sake. For more information and info on other Islander appearances, call the Islander Community Relations Department at 516-832-4206. Matt, we're going bowling, but we're not going bowling.
If you know what I mean, get the bowling shoes on. But how about the trade shoes, Stan Fischler? What have we learned from these first two periods?
We learned that Tommy Salo has enhanced his value as trade bait. Edmonton in a dogfight to get into the playoffs. He's the perfect guy for them. And I'll tell you something, he's going to go before the deadline.
All right, we'll see what happens. Boy, it looks like rain.
Well, that won't affect anything on the ice, unless the roof leaks. 2-1 New York as we get into the third period. Doug Brown in the corner, watched by Nemchinov. And then Pilon putting the body on Tomas Holmstrom, who tries to fight through it. Nemchinov fails to clear, but Janssen, who was spilled, did get it out of there. So Bill Stewart always preaching defensive responsibility. He knows his team can't open it up. The Detroit Red Wings, a team that'll go and get it. Remember, though, the Red Wings played last night. Will fatigue be a factor here in the third period? Pretty good contrast stylistically, and a pretty good setup for this third period with the Islanders holding a one-goal lead.
Well, it's a simple game, Howie, and if the Islanders continue to skate the way they did the first two periods, then, of course, they can do a lot of things. They can make Detroit make mistakes, and that's what you try to do, is to play solid, good hockey.
Twice this season, the Red Wings have come back to win when trailing at the end of two periods. Well, the Knicks and Nets are getting together, right? That'll be... It's the Nets' next game. That'll be on Monday on Fox Sports New York. Meantime, on MSG, the Knicks will play the Cleveland Cavaliers. So we got all kinds of NBA action coming up around here. Then again, they're going about every 5 minutes anyway. Chara throws one off a leg. Smolinski gets it back. Ought to have NBA teams playing doubleheaders to make up some of those games. Practically doing it anyway, going three nights in a row. Anders Ericsson back in the Detroit zone. Hard to remember now, but they had one season of NBA basketball in this building, 1970. Or was it two? I think it was two, actually. 75, 76. No, that was the last year of the ABA. So it was one, 76, 77. First year of the merger. And now Shanahan taken down by Linden. There'll be a penalty. Eddie, I know what you're thinking. Did he have enough room? No way, right?
No, can't be a penalty. You know what I was thinking? I was thinking back to the hook on Robert Reichel in the near the end of the second period, which was almost identical. The difference being, of course, the player, this Reichel didn't have the puck. He was trying to get into the play. In this case, Detroit had the puck. Trevor Linden is going to get the gate for hooking. That's where you don't want to be. You don't want to be in the position where you're forced to take a penalty to stop a breakaway, Howie, and that's what happened. Linden let him get a half a step on him. Shanahan, of course, all he needs is a half a step. He can power himself. That was Iserman. Look at the pass. Just beautiful stuff. And Trevor Linden forced to take the penalty.
Well, the Islander penalty killing has been outstanding tonight. They've allowed just three shots on three power plays against. So with Linden off, Bill Stewart's penalty killing unit, at least at the start, Lapointe and Watt up front, Janssen and Pilon back. And the power play of Detroit goes to work. Larionov and Murphy on the points. This is Kozlov with Lapointe and Fedorov up front, at least for the time being. And Shanahan had just been out there, centering feet. Kozlov, that's stopped by Salo. And then Lapointe fanned on the rebound.
Well, Tommy Salo made a mistake, Howie. He didn't control the puck loose around his net as well as he should have, but he backed himself up with a nice stop. That puck hit somebody on the Islanders' bench. The stoppage of play, but Tommy Salo, he had a chance. He could either smother the puck or move it off into the corner. And it seemed as though he hesitated, and in doing so, he set up a scoring chance, or helped Detroit set one up, but he did make the save.
So the draw will come outside the Islander blue line. Now it's Nemchinov and Seko, rather than Claude Lapointe, up front on the power play. Larry Murphy dumps it around the boards. And Seko has it back, but he lost it to Lapointe of Detroit. Larionov to the blue line to Fedorov. Murphy gets it back to Fedorov. Long drive, pants save, rebound was missed by Murphy. And again, Salo left a rebound.
Well, he had to there, Howie. There isn't anything. There isn't a goaltender that isn't going to leave a rebound under those circumstances.
Kozlov centered. Salo got a stick on that. Bouncing puck, cleared away from Larionov.
Boy, you can see Sacco there, Howie. The responsibility of the penalty killers, in this case, one of the forwards, Sacco, when that puck is on your stick, you've got to get it out into the center ice area, preferably down the ice.
And Salo holds on here with 50 seconds remaining to the power play. It'll be interesting to see if Salo is traded when you consider that Felix Potvin is not likely to be ready by the trade deadline.
Take a look. There's the play that moments ago that Sacco, you know, he had the puck. Just a quick flick of the wrist up against the boards. Get it out into the center ice area. You don't have to get it down the ice. Sometimes you just can't do that. But anyway, you just can't leave and particularly lose control of the puck or be checked in that area.
The Edmonton Oilers were one of those reportedly interested in Salo earlier. They brought up Steve Passmore, their third goaltender this year. Salo making a save there. Lachance put it to the wall. Sent down low once again. Bouncing puck. Fedorov unable to get a shot off.
Oh, he got a shot away, Howie. That was a left pad save. Tommy Salo took it off his left pad right near his knee. Another good stop. The Islanders making some mistakes in their own end of the ice.
Now, Iserman watched by Lachance. Iserman throws it back to the point. Lidstrom to Fedorov, but it went past him. Now he recovers. Fires one. And that winds up coming around the boards. Closing seconds of the power play. Fedorov, checked by Chara. Backing up is Lidstrom. And there's going to be a penalty to the Red Wings here.
Shanahan's going to get it for holding, I believe, is the signal I see coming from the referee, Dave Jackson. A holding penalty on Shanahan. Quaddle pointed a smart thing, Howie. He did a little acting. They were desperate. Detroit buzzing around the Islanders' end. Sallow making back-to-back saves off sharpshooters like Fedorov. And Shanahan got his stick on Claude Lapointe. Here's Fedorov. There's Shanahan, 14 in red. You see him there, he had a hold of the stick. Lapointe goes backwards as if saying, I can't get my stick and my arms loose. Referee said, I agree. Penalty. But some good stocks. Tommy Sallow right there. What a stop by Sallow. Point blank range. Made a beautiful save. He's held his poise. Here it is again. Boom, right there. Good save by Sallow. Boy, I don't know. I'm a Sallow fan, I admit it. I haven't been a Sallow fan since he arrived here. I like the way he handles himself. I like the way when he's under pressure and they turn him loose. Don't play with his head. Just turn him loose and let him play Goldie and have some protection for him. Yes, he does give up rebounds, but if you know that and you're playing on his team, then you have to be ready to help him. A lot of goaltenders that are good, outstanding goaltenders give up rebounds.
Well, if they did turn him loose, meaning move him, and assuming another goaltender is not part of the transaction, Marcel Cousineau has been playing pretty well down at Lowell. There's going to be a penalty here to the Islanders as Ward was taken down. And so that'll take care of an Islander power play that lasted 17 seconds.
Got to be smart when you're playing hockey. You can't take in the offensive zone. Power play in your favor, kind of things that can lose hockey games. Here, momentum can shift back and forth. Now, Detroit gets a bit of a break. They are a team that have a lot of players to take advantage of mistakes. And here are the Islanders in the offensive zone. Watch over on the right side of your screen, right there. Don't do it. Don't get that close to a guy. Don't even get that close with your stick, particularly if they're going to start taking dives. We've seen a couple of those now in this hockey game where teams have been taking dives, calling attention, and the referee has been falling for it, making the call.
So 4-on-4 here, which should be an advantage to the Detroit Red Wings when you consider how many earlier who took a slash and kept going.
Point broke his stick over his arm.
Larionov in the corner in the Red Wings zone. Got it to Dandino. 58 seconds, the Red Wings will get a mini power play. It'll be of just 17 seconds duration. Larionov slides across ice again. The Red Wings were changing. Murphy had to hustle back to the bench. Dandino powers in and missed the net. And Al Linden takes over for the Islanders. 4:40 gone in the third. It's 2-1 New York. The goals coming in the second period.
Islanders are trying to make a change here, Howie, and they mishandled the puck, giving it away to Fedorov.
And now Fedorov finds Doug Brown into the Islanders' zone. Sets up in front, looking for Fedorov, who is heading that way to deflect it, but Sallow holds on. 4:57 gone in the third. Islanders still up a goal.
Days of pushing me around are through. I got a better offer and I'm grabbing it. They even offered me a bonus. Can you even say that?
Bonus.
Bonus. Knock, knock. Who's there? A bonus.
Expect more from your credit card. Introducing Discover Platinum. With a new low rate and a cashback bonus award, it pays to discover Platinum.
Hello, bonus. Speaking.
He asked for more ice time, Howie. Better off, he and Shanahan both, and they've been getting it. They kind of released them right now in this season, too, from the left wing lock, which they have incorporated. And the other thing that they haven't done a lot in this hockey game, maybe the power plays, but that's understandable, but they don't use those five-man units that they're famous for. And Davey Lewis telling me before the hockey game, along with Scotty Bowman, that, they use it when they play Dallas and when they play some of the other teams, the more elite teams in the league, they go back to that five-man unit in their shifts.
Kenny Johnson for the Islanders, lugging it out of his own zone. Knocked down, there's going to be a penalty to the Red Wings here. Lidstrom comes back to touch up. It'll go as an icing, but a penalty as well. And the Islanders now will have a 4-on-3 skating advantage, briefly.
Hooking is the call, Jackson. Sergei Fedorov. Center ice area. Scotty checking up at the board. He wants to see the time. There's 14 minutes and 53 seconds left, Scotty, if you want some help. But right from the faceoff. Little argument. Fedorov is supposed to put his stick down first. Now look, Claude Lapointe. As he's mad, gets beat. But wait a minute, when you think about it, in 18, there's the penalty that Fedorov takes, I guess in exasperation. But through two periods, Claude Lapointe had taken 18 faceoffs. He won 14 and lost 4.
Well, maybe the most overword used in sports these days is focus. But at least in a literal sense, what Fedorov probably lost there was his focus, because he seemed so upset at having been ordered the way he was to get that stick down first, that he had to on the road. I mean, the visiting player's got to do that. Yeah, that he used that frustration or lack of focus to take the penalty.
Yeah, how can some linesman making $30,000 or $40,000 a year tell him, guy making $7 or $8 million, that he has to put his stick down first? How crazy is he?
Johnson played it behind Palfi. And in case you're wondering, if you're relatively new to the game or maybe don't follow every detail, the visiting player in these face-off situations has to put that stick down first. And that's exactly what the linesman in that situation, Tim Noack, was explaining to Sergei Fedorov. Fedorov winds up in the penalty box. So now the Islanders on the power play for another minute and 5 seconds. Cherkovsky to Linden. Hodson stuck out his stick. Richter has it back. Barry Richter floats one just wide. Richter has one of the Islander two goals. Johnson to Smolinski. And he didn't get all of it on that shot.
Yeah, then Marius Tchaikovsky falls down, going to the puck in the corner without anybody around him. Islanders lose control.
And Maltby almost got through. He beat Richter for the most part, but Kenny Johnson made sure to stay with him. Now he peels Maltby back off the puck. Maltby had lost his stick. Maltby's been talking to the referee, but now he heads to the bench. Tchaikovsky carries in, sets up Lawrence for a shot. Hudson the save, and he holds on. And Lawrence and Ward exchange sticks.
Good opportunities in the hockey game. Not that many you're going to get against the Detroit Red Wings, Howie. So when they come up, you better make them good. Not necessarily put the puck in the net, but you've got to make the goaltender make a save. Ryan Smolinski is an excellent puck controller and shooter. Here the puck, look, he looked up in defense, and there, look at Marius Tchaikovsky. Down he goes. Maltby comes back the other way, tries to split the outer defenders. Then he gets ridden into the boards. Now he says, give me the puck. I want to hang on to it. Let's play hide the puck. The guys are saying no. Look at him. He gets peeled back. Now he's yelling at the referee, like it's the referee's fault that he got down on his knees. What about a hockey stick? And Brian Smolinski, when he looked up, he was looking to see where would be a good place to shoot the puck. And the puck did move on him as he fired it off the heel of the stick.
So 23 seconds remain to the Red Wing penalty to Fedorov. 13:15 left in the third. Quick shot off the draw by Reichel. And it's stopped by Hodson. Coffey holds it in, then he gave it up. And Lidstrom works it out of the zone. Now Murphy to the Islander line. Murphy trying to kill off the rest of the penalty, thinking more attack too now. Cardi had gone to the front of the net. Pass comes all the way through, and this will finish the penalty as Fedorov comes out of the box. So 12:48 remaining in the third. It's 2-1 New York. A steal by Palfi. Now Reichel in over the line with Donato. Had it poked away by Lidstrom. One man back for the Islanders. Here comes Yzerman. Closing towards the slot. Yzerman got tangled up with the skates of his own man, Larry Murphy. A break for the Islanders. And Reichel dumps it in. Anders Ericsson comes back to get it. Both teams changing on the fly here. Ericsson checked by Nemchinov, dropped it for Lapointe. That's Martin Lapointe, who floats one behind the net. Pair of 44s, Lawrence and Erickson. But it's Kozlov on the puck for Detroit. Cross ice to Erickson. All the way to the far side. Larionov put it in front. Martin Lapointe couldn't tee it up. Claude Lapointe for the Islanders does. And he shovels it up the boards, but not out. Held in by Erickson. Now to Kozlov, who fires, and Salo grabs it. Some sloppiness in the Islanders' zone, but Kozlov denied by Salo to keep New York in front.
Dodge Dakota, Dodge Ram, add more muscle, in a hurry.
I'm Stan Fischler. Some people think I'm opinionated.
I mean, Patrick Waugh's lost it.
But I'm just saying what's on my mind.
Trade him, get two good guys.
And now I want to hear what's on your mind. Do you disagree with something I've said? Would you like the NHL to do something different? Well, I want you to sound off.
Send your comments to this address or email us at msgnetwork.com. Subject sound off. Please include your name and daytime phone number.
If I hear from you, you might hear from me.
All the Islanders try to clear a puck, and it gets knocked out of the air. Erickson flagged it down. Lapointe off the boards, chases it down, chips it. Boom! Boy, that's terrible when it happens to you like that. Guy gets lucky, they get a scoring chance from it, and Tommy Salo comes up with another good save. There's the stop. Moving off to his left, teeing it up, Kozlov. He's got quick hands, he's got quick feet. Tommy Salo with a good stop.
From the draw, a chance for the Islanders comes to center. Did he get to the red line? He did not, but icing negated because Hansen played the puck with Lawrence bearing down on him. And it's Dandino in the Detroit zone. Islanders completing a change here as the Red Wings play it deep. Chara knocked down by Martin Lapointe. Actually, Lapointe got the stick up on him. And the puck nudged along. Joe Sacco out here with Smolinski and Linden. Craig Janney had started the game on that line, but has been used sparingly as the game has continued. And it's Sacco dumping into the far corner. In fact, through two periods, Janney only had eight shifts for a little more than 6 minutes. So Craig Janney, who had been scratched for a couple of games in a row, put up on the number two line tonight. Bill Stewart said this morning, play well, play more. Well, evidently, he wasn't too satisfied with what he saw because Janney has not played more. In fact, Janney only played a minute and 24 seconds in the second period. Sacco now chips it out of the Islanders' zone, lifted the other way by Ward, but that becomes a souvenir with 10:33 remaining in the third period. Islanders continue to lead the Red Wings here by a score of 2-1, with lots more action coming up both on the ice and on the hardwood this week. Janney hoping for more action on the ice, but tomorrow at noon, it'll be the Devils and the Coyotes on Fox Sports New York. And on Monday, the Nets and the Celtics with a 7 o'clock tip-off. That's on Fox Sports New York, while on MSG. The Knicks face the Cavs at 7:30. Tuesday on Fox Sports New York, the Islanders will play the Senators. And then on Thursday, make sure to tune to MSG at 7 as the Rangers visit D.C. Lots of hockey and hoops this week, so check your local listings. Doug Brown in the Detroit zone. Islanders have Donato up on that first line tonight with Palfy and Reichel. They're out there now. Holmstrom spins it around the boards. Mike Watt had seen a few games as the left wing on the top line. He had not produced points. And now it's Brown for Detroit. That loose stick belongs to Donato, and that's why Donato had to go down and just sweep the puck out with his hand.
That's a good second effort, Howie.
It's going to be a penalty to the Islanders anyway here. They get the goaltender to the bench, the Red Wings do, so they've got an extra skater here. Yzerman setting up shop in the corner. Drifting back into the circle. Sets up Lidstrom, and now Yzerman again. Yzerman closes it, shoots, and that's knocked away, but it comes right to Murphy. Sets up Yzerman. That one's blocked by Pilon and looks to have hurt him.
He's in a lot of pain, Howie. It looked like it may have hit him around the left hand or the left elbow. Not sure right now. He's getting himself over to the bench. When you get pain like that, you want to keep moving. You want to get off the ice first, and you want to just get off and be quiet. Now he's going to tell Mitch Campbell. It was a point-blank shot. He was going down to block it right there. Wham! Look at him. See his left hand snap up? That's hit him in the arm or in the wrist. Ooh. That was a real ripper. One-timer, whack.
Would you feel something like that through the equipment?
I feel that all the way up here. Oh, yeah. Watch Fedorov down here in the lower left. Look at him calling for the puck. I'm wide open. Get it over to me. Somebody gets to him, but Rich Pilon, now as he goes down in front, right here. Bang. Ouch. Ooh.
Yeah. There are areas on the lower arm, obviously, where you're not as well protected
I'll tell you,
as with the cuff of the glove.
Anywhere above the glove, and you don't know the position of the glove, because if your glove and your hand is turned, the glove is exposing more of your arm and your wrist. If that hits you on the arm, it just hits right on the bone. Take another look at that shot. Look at the stick bend. Man, he got a lot on that, too, and he just ripped it. And Rich Pilon gets in front of it. Ooh, that'll be a big hematoma, they call that.
So Reichel for the hold at 10:24. And the Red Wings on the power play here. Shanahan hit by LaChance. Shanahan around to Yzerman. Yzerman backing up before returning to Shanahan. He's hounded by LaChance. That forced the giveaway. Zdeno Chara strolls to center. Now to Linden. Arianov stumbled. But Linden still throws it back into his own zone to kill some time. Before he played it off of Kozlov. So Shanahan, last one, big save, Salo, and then it's clear.
Wow, see the Islanders, Howie, they had an opportunity. They got a little lazy. I wouldn't say lazy. They got a little thoughtless. Chara had the puck, he had lots of time, and then all of a sudden he didn't have much time. He panicked a little and gave the puck away. Shanahan with a blistering shot. What a stop by Tommy Salo.
Yzerman couldn't control the fluttering puck. He's challenged by Nemchinov. And he moves it on to Kozlov. Nice play by Larionov to tee it up with his skate. Doug Brown down the boards. Couldn't find Shanahan with it. Now it's Johnsson. Away from one. Then another. Couldn't get away from three of them. However, he did the job anyway because the puck wound up deflecting into the seats.
And they're all pointing at the Detroit players, saying it went off them. That means the faceoff should go outside the blue line. And the Islanders, they're right. But what a chance by Shanahan. Brendan Shanahan picks off a mistake by Zdeno Chara, walks in, and does he get something on that baby? Wow! Right pad save. See how Tommy Salo snapped back up, Holly? He made the save. And here again, folks, trust me, you can't control rebounds off shots that are coming from that close, off sticks that are moving that fast. Brendan Shanahan has a tremendous drive, and he used it there.
Rich Pilon, by the way, went to the Islander dressing room. Elliot Pellman, the Islanders team physician, on his way through the runway to attend to Pilon. So if we get any information on the extent of that injury, we'll pass it along to you. 33 seconds remain to the Detroit power play. Linden stole it from Fedorov. Sets up a point for a backhander off the shoulder of Hudson. Apparently they were working on the thumb of Rich Pilon over on the Islander bench. Now Holmstrom, closing seconds of the power play to Lidstrom. Salo a save. Rebound skirts behind the net. Barry Richter's got it. Out muscled Brown and cleared it all the way down.
Well, that should just about do it, Howie. What a lift this should be to the Islander team. Not only the goaltending of Salo, but the penalty-killing unit doing a great job.
Penalty's over. Maltby denied on a kick save by Salo. And now Palfy carries out, however. Puck knocked down with a high stick will negate the rush. 7:28 remaining in the third period. The Islanders just killed off another Detroit power play. So now the Red Wings 0-5.
Feeling burnt out? Tired of the daily grind?
I just...
1-800-COLLECT and the new movie Office Space can help. Make your next call with 1-800-COLLECT, the cheap way to call collect, and you could win a year's pay. Now, every completed 1-800-COLLECT call enters you for a chance to win $50,000,
Greg,
to do whatever you want.
I would do nothing.
The more 1-800-COLLECT calls you make, the more chances you have to win. Call 1-800-COLLECT today and check out the new movie Office Space.
At this point,
Coliseum has come alive and just buried him. Pyle's doing a great job. Donato cuts the middle. Shot. And a hit on Savage at the center in front. Score!
Zane, score!
Puck knocked away. Here comes Pilon and Zane. Trevor Linden pumps his fist in the air. Score!
Get in on the action. To purchase your Islander tickets, call 1-888-ETM-TIXS. For the ticket machine near you or to order by phone.
We will rock you. This place has been rocking now for, it's 7 minutes and 28 seconds short of a whole hockey game. Fans are loving a good game here between Detroit and the Islanders. Islanders right now holding on to a 2-1 lead. They've got to get back now to see whether or not that penalty kill that they just had helps them out.
Red Wings have outshot New York 10-4 here in the third period. Islanders have one of their biggest crowds of the year here tonight, a little over 13,000. We'd certainly expect a nice crowd tonight on a Saturday night, the only visit of the year by the two-time defending Stanley Cup champions. And it's been a lively crowd as well. A chance behind the Islander net, challenged by McCarty. Eric Brewer failed to clear. Draper got a piece of it. Bandino put it in front. Lachance swept it away. Now McCarty centers. They score. Draper has tied it for Detroit.
Brewer made the mistake, Howie, and it was directly in front of him that the deflection was made. Detroit has tied it up. What they couldn't do on the power play, they've done here at even strength. The Islanders again had the puck in their own end of the ice. They had control of it. Watch number 4 in white. Brewer has control later on and then loses it. And there the deflection. Beautiful pass in front. Instinct will do it every time. Fire it to the front of the net. Players know that if you have a chance, that's the place to put it.
Well, here we go again. Did he have a skate in the crease? It's going to be reviewed. Yeah.
Yes, he did.
I bet you that's no goal.
Counting. It's not going to count. That deflection by Draper is not going to work, folks. Watch the right skate of the guy in red right there. It's in the crease. Here comes the puck. He's still in the crease.
And did you see Brewer take his arms off to make sure it was clear that he had nothing to do with putting him in there? At least that's the way I interpret it.
Well, the Islanders make a mistake, so they're going to get some help here because that cannot count according to the rules. And the referee now talking.
No goal.
No goal, yeah. Well, with a penalty kill that they just had, actually back-to-back penalty killing for the Islanders, and a goal taken away. The Islanders have lost one in this hockey game as well, but now can they get things back together? They can't make those kinds of mistakes that Brewer just made. Jadeno Chara made it when Shanahan had a great shot at Tommy Salo, who Salo stopped, but you can't keep making those mistakes against the Detroit team that's got too many guys that can put the game away.
You know, anytime there's a goal scored as the result of a player driving to the net, you have to hedge. You have to wait to see whether or not there'll A, be a review, and B, a reversal. We had both of them there, and Draper will try to lift his leg here.
We're showing that because it looks as though he was lifting his right foot as if he knew that his foot was in the crease. I guess it was just a little too late. Islanders are in trouble now, Howie. They're just not making the plays that they need to make cleanly to get out of their own end.
6:46 still to be played here in the third period. So the Islanders continue to lead 2-1. Each team has lost a goal to video review, and the Islanders lose that rush to an offside. Lawrence was ahead of the play.
That's what happens when players out there don't have the experience. They panic a little bit. That's a good look at Draper, who has just seen a goal that he thought had tied the score in two. Taken away. Shaking his head. Made a good effort to get his right foot out of the goal crease. Let's take another look at that. Watch his right foot. Watch this. It's in. And now he tries to lift it up, and it looked like he made it. From that angle, it looks like it should count, as if he got his right foot up. His left one was outside the goal crease. On that video replay, you'd have to give him the goal.
Of course, then the other argument is, well, if he lifted it, was it across the plane of the crease? I mean, it's become so technical.
Yeah, well, that's a good point.
Or was it still in the goal crease when the puck got in there with it?
So Lidstrom goes cross ice to Murphy at the Detroit line. Red Wings attack again. Fedorov drifts back, put it off of Chara's leg, and then high sticks Chara violently. There's going to be a major penalty, or should be here. Zdeno Chara just got whacked right across the head.
Who's going to go after Larionov? If that's what I thought it was, there should be a few guys climbing on his frame. I wouldn't close the door yet. He's out of the hockey game. I'd almost bet that he's gone, and he should be gone. He is, because he's now there. Fedorov is yelling at the referee. The linesmen are staying between the two. Zdeno Chara is still down on the ice.
Now, Zdeno Chara earlier this year suffered an injury where he came within a hair losing an eye to a skate blade.
That was an accident, Howie, and I remember seeing that. I was here, but boy, this was a deliberate motion, and I have no patience. I don't care who you are in a hockey game. No patience for deliberately trying to injure another player.
Elliot Pellman, the Islanders team physician, had gone to the Islander room just about 5 or so minutes ago to check on Rich Pilon, who had blocked a shot, was having his thumb worked out on the bench, and then went off for further examination and repair. And presumably, Doc's going to have to come back and take another look. This time it's Zdeno Chara.
Things like this, Howie, are very hard to defend, even if you're a teammate. Let's take a look at it. There's Zdeno Chara. He can't. Oh, look at that. Fedorov had a hold of his stick, had a hold of Chara's stick, and then just with an axe move, swung that thing like a pole axe and hammered him right across the face. What a cowardly act. I can't believe hockey players do that. Look at that. Just took it and whacked him right. He knew exactly where he was swinging it, too. That wasn't an accident. He can't think for a minute that there's anything accidental about it.
John D'Amico, the Hall of Fame linesman, who's now a supervisor of officials, is at the game tonight. Presumably saw that one firsthand, which could affect any disciplinary action, aside from the match penalty being given now to Fedorov.
Well, I guess I snapped.
What did you do?
Well, there was a pair of scissors.
You didn't.
I did. Snip, snip.
Anything left?
Just tiny little pieces.
You did the right thing.
And thank you for switching to Discover Platinum.
Expect more from your credit card. Introducing Discover Platinum. With a new low rate and a cashback bonus award, it pays to discover. Platinum. Call 1-800-DISCOVER.
Got another snipper.
Get excited next time you get behind the wheel. Get into the 99 Pontiac Grand Prix GT sedan with wide track performance, V6, and a $306 per month GMAC smart lease with just $306 due at lease signing. Or the redesigned Grand Am sedan, solid unibody construction, twin cam engine, lease for $229 a month with zero money due at lease signing. See your Tri-State Pontiac dealer by March 1st. Hurry.
We sell excitement.
Well, I shake my head and I actually shudder when I see things like this happen, and it just drives me absolutely nuts. And we're gonna take another look. Watch Fedorov now over on the left side. He's down on the ice. He's got a hole. Look at that. I don't believe that he did that. And you know what makes me also mad? Where were the Islanders? Why weren't they climbing all over that Fedorov? They should have been carrying him out of here, even if it's gonna cost you some money. I'll tell you what, the team would pay for it, or we'd take up a collection. I mean, that's just unforgivable.
Yeah, you know, there was one shift earlier in the game. Remember when Martin LaPointe and Aaron Ward, actually it was LaPointe of Detroit, who wound up getting a stick up on Smolinski, and Trevor Linden and one of the other Islanders, Chara, in fact, went to the aid of Smolinski. But on this play, it was so violent. I agree with you. I'm surprised that somebody didn't plow into Fedorov right away.
They should have been. Everybody on the ice should have been right after him. And if they couldn't get to him, it wasn't because they didn't try. You know, Howie, it's things like that that go on television, and they show it, and they show it. And it takes a wonderful game. Here we've had a wonderful hockey game. And you know what's going to be known for? That incident.
And I say they're not wrong in one way. They should play it, and that guy should suffer the biggest penalty. If they're going to give Dale Hunter 21 games, when Gary Bettman came into this league, the first thing he did was he gave a 21-game suspension for nothing. Well, it was next to nothing. I disagreed with it. That's the kind of thing that should cost that guy so much and so much time. His team should lose him, and he should lose his whole salary. Period.
Well, it's certainly suspendable because it's a match penalty, so that's an automatic review. It's a 5-minute major power play for the Islanders, but the match penalty means it's subject to immediate review. John DeMeco, one of the supervisors of officials in the NHL, is here tonight. And once that tape gets into the hands of Colin Campbell, you would have to assume that there will be further disciplinary action. Centering feed, Lawrence, he scores! And they've got a whole lot more power play time to play with.
Well, it's almost as if Detroit had let up, Howie. They just looked almost disinterested, and the Islanders picked them apart, and they got it, what they needed. Good passing play, good offensive moves. The Islanders had not been in Detroit's end for quite some time, and they're coming in from the side. Lawrence. Mark Lawrence, almost as if he didn't think the puck was going to make it in. Right there. He's starting to jab at it. He gets checked by Murphy, but the puck continued on. Across the goal line, into the net.
So the Islanders still with 4 minutes of power play time to their credit. 5 minutes to go in the third. A huge goal gives them a 2-goal lead. Against the Stanley Cup champion Red Wings. Play stopped here with 4:46 remaining in the third period. Goal number 8 of the year for Mark Lawrence coming on the power play.
You know, that's the kind of thing, too, that also invites civil action. If Zdeno Chara, I mean, I'm making maybe too much out of it, but I don't think so. Not when you swing your stick like that. If Zdeno Chara loses, if he was hurt severely enough that he couldn't play anymore, here's a young player with a bright future. You think for a minute that there wouldn't be some thought on his side for a litigation?
Well, it happened during your playing days.
Yes, it did.
Involving Henry Boucher, wasn't it? Who played, I think, for Minnesota North Stars and Detroit Red Wings.
And
at the time,
should have happened a lot more times than it didn't. But those are the things. We'll only hope that Zdeno Chara isn't hurt badly.
Oh, was it Dennis Polonich of the Red Wings hit Boucher of the North Stars, right?
North Stars,
and
yeah.
Boucher suffered an eye injury, and I think that one went to the courts.
Yes, it did, and it was settled, too. It was a big number. Don't know exactly, but you're absolutely right. A long time ago, but it got into the civil courts.
Well, Bill Stewart with a concussion working behind the bench tonight. And his players have certainly responded. They've given a spirited effort from start to finish. 4:19 remaining in the third, so technically we're not finished yet. Donato being whacked at by Kozlov. Took Donato down, cleared the puck all the way down the ice. Remember, the Red Wings thought they had this one tied at 2 on a Draper goal. That was denied by a video review, and then the penalty by Fedorov, the major, a match penalty, setting up an Islander power play. Lawrence cashing in from Reichel and Palfy. That was Mark Lawrence's first power play goal in the National Hockey League. Reichel and Palfy each with 3 points in this game tonight, figuring in on all three goals. Not the first time we've seen Smoke do that with one of his sticks, but listen, if the Islanders win this, it'll be impressive, beating the champions. And the road doesn't get a whole lot easier either. Look what's coming up just in the next 10 days.
Well, I'll tell you, one step at a time, Howie. It has to be uplifting, not only for the fans here that are out supporting this hockey club, but for them. I mean, there's still a lot of hockey left against a very dangerous hockey team, even though the Islanders will play it out with a man advantage. But it's amazing what lessons players can learn. They don't realize how good they are sometimes until they can get an effort where they all work hard together.
Well, it's been sporadic for the Islanders. Bill Stewart has seemingly every other night delivered an impassioned plea about effort, intensity, playing for each other. He did that for quite a while after the game the other night against Toronto. That was after Thursday night's game. And the guy we just showed you on the bench a moment ago seems firmly seated now in Bill Stewart's Chateau Bow Wow. That's Craig Janney. Got a chance tonight playing on the second line, but didn't make much of it. Drive knocked away by Hodgson. And only got a little over a minute's ice time in the second. I don't believe we've seen him here in the third. Shanahan for Detroit, centered Iserman. He missed it. Had he connected, we probably would have had another review anyway. He was that close to the crease. Johnson behind the Islander net, 2:52 to go in the third. 1 minute less than that on the major power play. Linden sends Smolinski in. He couldn't hold the pass cleanly. So now he gives it back to Linden. LaChance just to get there in time to keep it onside. Trevor Linden for Donato. Linden again. And Donato in the corner. Smolinski floats to the front of the net. Dandino went down. The pass failed to come across, though. But Linden has it back. This is working fine for the Islanders because time's ticking away. Centering feed went off the skate of Ward. Islanders with a two-goal lead. Another minute 11 to the power play, the major power play, on which they've already scored once. Donato to Smolinski. He's being pressured here by Dandino. But Brewer takes it at the point, fires, it's tipped, it goes wide. Donato bumped off the puck by Dandino. Donato gets right back on it, though. Ted Donato to Smolinski. Now Smolinski drifting back, holding. Brewer, one-timer, that hit a leg. I believe it was that of Trevor Linden. And Iserman scoots in front of his own net. Smolinski ran into him after he released the puck, and here comes Iserman. Works on the chance, who gives him nothing. Poke the puck away. Iserman goes right back to it. 28 to the power play. After which there'll be just 1 minute to go in the third. Murphy hacking away at Smolinski.
You don't take a bad penalty now, Brian Smolinski.
Lidstrom sets up Draper, and he hit the goalpost. Draper on the backhand. And now Richter for the Islanders. Penalty winding down, but so's the game. The Islanders in control with a two-goal lead. And Hudson, the goaltender, started for the bench. Now he's at the hash marks. Out of the box is Roast, who is serving the time. He stays on the ice for the time being. Empty net missed by Claude Lapointe. 50 seconds remaining in the third. Red Wings with an extra skater on, their net is empty. And the Islanders with a two-goal advantage. Larionov up the middle. Kozlov trying to split through. Nothing doing. And we're down to 36 seconds to go. And the Islanders appear on the verge of a win against the champions. Larionov fires one. Salo grabs it. And Nemchinov fails to clear. He was checked by Larionov. Larionov back on it with 20 seconds to go. Salo with a save. And then Dandino had it come up and hit him in the face. Empty net. Sacco hits the red line. Shoots one off of Erickson. Lapointe goes to the net. Doesn't reach him, though. Doesn't matter. Only 8 seconds remain. Nemchinov throws it behind the net. Lapointe for the Islanders there. Sets up Richter. He hit the goalpost. Time running out. Janssen shot blocked, but who cares? The Islanders have beaten the Stanley Cup champion, Detroit Red Wings, 3-1.
Scotty Mullen said before the hockey game, Howie, that every team they play gets up to play against the defending Stanley Cup champion. And why would you expect it to be any different? Well, the Islanders got up for this one, and they stayed up for almost 60 minutes, and they pulled off a beautiful hockey game, a responsive fan group here tonight, and a big win for the Islanders. Ties the season series between the Detroit Red Wings and the Islanders.
Well, it's been almost 6 years since the Islanders last beat the Red Wings in this building. You have to go back to March 2nd of 93, last time that happened. So smiles all around as the Islanders, with an honest effort from start to finish, head off with a well-earned 3-1 win.
Yeah, you know, you can't overlook the fact, too, that they were in trouble a few times, penalty killing, and they were in trouble a few times making mistakes in their own end of the ice. And Tommy Salo had a solid, solid game.
And the three stars of the game appear to be all Islanders. Claude Lapointe was playing his 500th National Hockey League game tonight, and he comes up with a third star as part of his arsenal tonight. You know, Tommy Salo is going to be in there as well. Robert Reichel, along with Zygmunt Palfy, had a three-point night. His star number two. And the number one star of the game. The Red Wings peppered him with 34 shots. He stopped all but one, Tommy Salo.
Oh, yeah, great job. Deserved it. There's a couple other guys that deserved a lot of recognition as well, Howie. But, you know, it was a team effort, and that's really the most important thing.
So the Islanders with a 3-1 win over the Detroit Red Wings. We'll come back to wrap it up right after this.
At GEICO, we settle claims quickly so you can get your car back, because no one likes to bum a ride to work.